I got a hunch.
Testing live from the Everlight Solar Studio.
I would say that you are pretty easygoing. You're actually probably more easygoing than I am.
This is Wilde and Tausch, presented by Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin.
Well, there's no, you're not easygoing at all.
Hey!
On 100.5 ESPN, the ESPN app, and Wisconsin On Demand.
The Thursday edition. The no Wilde, no Tausch. How the heck do we keep this thing on the rails edition? The Nelson and Ellerson edition. How about that? Of Wilde and Tausch. Heck yeah. 94.5 ESPN Milwaukee, 100.5 ESPN Madison, 1430 ESPN Beaver Dam, Wisconsin On Demand. The ESPN app, Apple, Spotify, wherever you get your podcasts, streaming with live video on the ESPN Milwaukee, ESPN Madison YouTube channels. All right, let's get this all situated here. Nobody's in their regular spot right now. Tausch is at some undisclosed location somewhere worldwide. I have no idea. We'll find out when he's back next week. Jason Wilde has a couple of days off enjoying spring break with the family. So who's here? I'm usually the producer of the show. My name's Jesse Nelson. I'm in the Everlight Solar Studios at ESPN Madison. Hunter Vaughn is behind the glass filling in as our, I guess, one of our two, or is it three, cousin subs of the day. Cousin subs we believe in better. Hunter, good morning.
Good morning.
You're a Cowboys fan. We're going to get into that as we continue on in the show here today because there is some stuff to talk about relating to the Green Bay Packers and the Dallas Cowboys. But, of course, our featured special guest cousin sub of the day for the second day of three consecutive at his undisclosed location. He is one of the GOATs. He is Gary Ellerson. Gary, good morning. Yesterday I was talking to you behind the glass. Today I'm talking to you here in my little box on the video stream. How you doing, my friend?
Good, buddy. So where are you now?
So I'm in Madison at the Everlight Solar Studios at ESPN Madison. Yep, that's where I am. Okay. So usually I'm over in Hunter's seat behind the glass. Today I'm in front of the glass. Okay. I got the TVs on. Okay. This is a much better seat than that seat. It's a little temperature controlled better in this part of the room. So I hope I don't get too used to being in here. Gary, I do want to say something before we get started here. And I don't want you to feel – this is what I don't want to do. I don't want you to feel old by what I say. I don't want to do that to you. Sometimes I do that to Jason and Tausch, and I like to say, like, when Jason first started covering the Packers, that I was in, like, fourth grade. Like, that's a fun thing to throw at him every now and then. Here's all I want to say. I'm very excited to do this show, hosting it with you today. Because as someone growing up in southeast Wisconsin who first learned what sports radio was by listening to your show a decade and a half ago, now to be on the air doing the show with you, I don't know if I'd go as far as to say it's a dream come true. I don't know if I would go there. But
Don't overdo it. It is
a really cool moment for me to be able to do this show here today and tomorrow with you. So thank you for coming along for the ride, no matter how far I try and derail this ship.
I'm glad you said ship. I thought you were going to say something else. Clean that up pretty good.
I always try to emphasize the P, knowing what Hunter's role is behind the glass producing the show. Ship is usually what we like to do there. 844.
Hey, well, I'm glad to be here. How about that?
We're so happy to have you. Great insight yesterday with Jason. Again, if you missed any of yesterday's show, you can subscribe. Full show podcast available. Apple, Spotify, Wisconsin On Demand, wherever you get your podcast. The number to get into the show today is 844-770-3776. I am excited to host the show with Gary Ellerson. We have Evan Cohen of Unsportsmanlike on ESPN Radio scheduled to appear at his usual time coming up at 9:30. Jason did not trust us to steer this ship without him, so he is scheduled to appear around 10:30 this morning because he's getting the itch that, you know, he doesn't want us to commandeer the entire operation without him being involved in some capacity. So Jason is actually scheduled to appear to join us and share some Packers knowledge with us a little bit later in the show as well.
Don't you feel like that's almost like You're leaving the kids home alone to watch the house, but yet you're close enough to come back home to check on the kids to make sure they're not having a party.
That's exactly what it is, which is perfectly on brand for Jason Wilde. Like, that's exactly how I envision the several of the coming years will go for him. So, yes, that's exactly, it's like the, or my other comparison would be, it's like the teacher is out for the week and the substitute teacher's in, but the teacher's coming by every day just to check on the class to see how it's going. Like, I think your analogy is probably better than mine, but either way, it feels like that's on brand with what Jason would do. So that is exactly what's happening when Jason stops by about midway through the show today. 844-770-3776 is the number to get into the show. I'm almost excited as much to host with Gary as I was looking forward to Brewers opening day today. However, we will now remember this as the day we almost celebrated Brewers opening day, as they have been rained out in New York City, and opening day has been rescheduled to tomorrow.
It is gone! No, he didn't!
Thank you, Paul Allen. So, Gary, I want to ask you this. Did it feel like today was going to be opening day to you? Did you have this day circled as like, oh, the Brewers are opening on Thursday? Can't wait to see that, to see what the squad's got in 2024. Did you have any inclination that opening day was even taking place today, originally scheduled?
Well, because it's my job to know, right? So yeah, obviously I know. But I think probably the bigger question for me is, am I interested anymore in really baseball in itself? Really maybe the Brewers. I think I've lost something, Jesse, with the Brewers over the last 4 or 5 years. Because for me, it still feels like the Brewers are the same Brewers that I've been watching, that they just break my heart. The Bucks are kind of getting that way for me a little bit too, where although I'm interested in seeing what's happening, but I know they take me to a certain point, and that's all I'm going to go. I'm not going to get any further than that. So it's kind of like watching this car wreck. I know it's going to happen, and I know about when it's going to happen, and it's going to break my heart. So it's tough for me to get invested in the Brewers.
Wow.
Do I watch the games? Yeah, I watch the games. I mean, but I'm not as really focused on it like I used to be, because they can never really beat the Dodgers. They can never really beat those teams that are out there that they've lost to in years past. I mean, they've only have gotten us so far, and they break my heart every single time.
Well, that's interesting. I was going to go somewhere different with this, but now you've piqued my interest, Gary, because couldn't you say the same thing for the last decade and a half about the Green Bay Packers?
You can, but it feels different with them only because football is king. The NFL has found a way to make it exciting all the time. There may be, Jesse, if you think about it, there may be 2, maybe 3 weeks out of a year, and not all at the same time, where football doesn't exist. I mean, you got the draft, you got free agency, you've got the combine. I mean, they've always, and now, whether you like it or not, they're on Christmas Day. So they've taken the NBA, what are you going to do? That was their big thing, and now they're taking control of really Christmas Day. So, yeah, you could say that about the NFL, but you can also say that about the Green Bay Packers, because you can go back, you talk about the Seattle game, you can talk about the 49ers that Rodgers could never really beat. There are a lot of games out there where they've never really gotten to that point, but it just doesn't feel the same to me. It's not the same comparison, but I can see where you're coming from. And maybe I'm just more of a Packer fan than I am a Brewers fan.
Well, I would imagine so. A little allegiance to the Green Bay Packers from your playing career that would probably lean you that way over. I don't think I ever remember you suiting up for the Brewers.
How about this? You know who else is in that same category?
Who?
For me? The Wisconsin Badgers football team.
Wow. How so?
The Wisconsin Badgers won't get you over the hump? Yeah, the basketball team, the Badgers basketball team, same thing, only to a certain point, and then here comes the disappointment. Both one and the same.
So pretty much every, I mean, you also mentioned the Bucks, even though they just came off a championship run a few years ago. So pretty much every Wisconsin football team, you're saying, is in the same camp of
they break my heart.
Success with heartbreaking disappointments come postseason time.
Don't you feel that way?
I do. Not to the same extent, I think, where I lose interest, but it's a very interesting thing to consider, and I'm curious what our fans would say. 844-770-3776 is the ESPN Wisconsin Talk and Text line. If you'd like to weigh in, have you lost interest in the Milwaukee Brewers because of the heartbreaking postseason losses? 844-770-3776. Because, Gary, like I started the show mentioning, when I listened to you growing up, like, the Brewers were not very good for a long time. Like, I mentioned on the show all the time, it's one of our running jokes. My dad was an usher at Miller Park for a number of years, and I would go to a bunch of games in the early 2000s when tickets were easily a dollar to get in, and there'd be 5,000 people there, and you know the team was losing 100 games. But it was fun because you always thought about, oh, Prince Fielder's coming, J.J. Hardy's coming, Ricky Weeks is on the horizon, Ben Sheets is kind of that guy that could be your ace. And there was always this eternal optimism of what could be. It's fascinating to me, Gary, that we're in what I think many would say, without having a championship, is the golden age of Brewers baseball. Consecutive playoff appearances, continuous bites at the apple, all-star talent that's been leading the way on a national scale. Like, it's been since, 2018? The Brewers have been in the mix every year, competing for a chance to get to the World Series. And so even though the team has gotten consistently better than they were a decade and a half ago, now you actually have this level of wake me up in the playoffs, or, well, let's see if they can do it in October, because I know they're going to probably be in the mix in mid-September, late September. Yeah, pennant race is where you want to be. But it almost diminishes the value of games in April, May, June, July, because you're so much concentrating on what's happening later. Just like, as you mentioned, with Badger basketball, we've been down the road of the big games in November, December, January, Big Ten opponents, those non-conference tournaments at the start of the year around Thanksgiving. Now it's about, what are you going to do in March? And like Tausch is a wake-me-up-in-March guy. The Badgers woke him up in March for the Big Ten tournament, and then they put him back to bed by losing to James Madison.
Exactly. And you knew what was going to happen. How you did not know that wasn't going to happen? You did. I think when you talk about baseball, I mean, the revenue sharing, obviously, that's a big deal. And then it always feels like we have to develop players, which we've done a great job of doing that. But we're always trying to catch lightning in a bottle. I mean, you just look at these other franchises that can spend the money all the time. We got to be able to develop this talent. And I think that can only get you so far when you look at our budget and the way we are able to do things. I mean, why did really Craig Counsell, why did he really leave the Brewers and go to the Cubs?
Because he wanted to become the biggest villain in baseball, only to be outdone by Shohei Ohtani.
Okay. Right. Okay, well, maybe so. But I think at the end of the day, it was about money, and it was about the dollars. Yeah, maybe the Cubs are historically a better organization than the Brewers, and maybe there's something behind that. But I think at the end of the day, Craig Counsell went for the money and made the money in Chicago. They were able to do that. We couldn't do that for him here in Milwaukee. And I think ultimately that's what hurt the Brewers by getting players that they need to get. And that's why we can never really get over the hump. Am I happy that we're in the playoffs every year? Sure, I am. But at the end, I've seen it, and I know how the story ends.
But I'd argue, Gary, and again, I consider myself to be a big Brewers fan. Now, I will admit, like you, Gary, I have lost a little bit of day-to-day interest in the team over the last couple of years. And I don't know if that's just because I've gotten older and life has changed, or if it's more because of what you're saying about the metrics by which I measure how much investment I put into the Milwaukee Brewers. So I'd never really considered the latter to be an option until you just brought this up. But now that I think more about it, when the team, you're saying they can't get over the hump because of the money situation. I think they can.
Correct.
And I think they've been on the doorstep of doing it. They went to Game 7 of the NLCS in 2018 against the Dodgers, the big bad Dodgers with this huge payroll. They were right there in the mix with a chance to close out that series in Game 7 at home. In 2021, they had the number two seed in the National League playoffs. They lost to the Red Hot Braves as they came in, but they had multiple opportunities on the road in Atlanta to try and seal a victory and get back and again get to an NLCS. It's happened more than one occasion where the Brewers have been in a position to still compete for a chance to get to a World Series, more so than ever before. Outside of what, 1982, the one other time that they were really right there at the doorstep of winning a potential championship. So for me, it's interesting to hear you say that the metric by which you measure the team has changed, because I've always thought that baseball, it's just the grind of the season, and it's just, they play every single day. And I'd love to watch every single game and be on the edge of my seat, but it's just not the same as a football game when there's only 16 in the regular, 17 now in the regular season, and everything matters more. College football, every play matters, because if you lose one game, two games, your season's over. Baseball doesn't have that same urgency, but likewise, the success of the regular season for the Brewers lately with the matched lack of success in the postseason kind of feels like watching a Packers game against the Jaguars in week 8 versus a Packers game in the divisional round or in the NFC championship.
Jesse, as you were just spewing off all those things, the accomplishments that the Brewers have made in years past got me upset. Bridesmaid, but never the bride. I mean, at some point, they got to get married to somebody. And to me, that means get to the World Series. And to me, I think it's tougher the way the system is set up for them to get there. They are an organization that's always trying to catch lightning in a bottle and trying to do it with less funds, because that's the way it's set up. They can never go get really the best player out there. They've got to go get the second rung of players, bring all these guys together and hope that it works out. I mean, of course, they went and got Christian Yelich, and then he had an amazing season for us. Then what happened to him? All of a sudden, he kind of fell off the boat a little bit and wasn't the MVP guy that he was. And I don't know what happened to that, but we were banking on him to take us to that next level, right? We were banking on him to fill the shoes of Ryan Braun. You just go back to Ryan Braun. Ryan Braun got into that little incident. Well, maybe it was and maybe it wasn't. Steroids or whatever that was, right? And then that kind of fell off the boat a little bit. And then you're right. You can talk about the Prince Fielder, Ryan Braun, Ricky Weeks. And all those were very exciting times for the Brewers. I mean, I saw those guys. I believe they were with the – was that the Beloit Snappers or the Beloit team down there when they were coming up?
Now the Sky Carp, but they were the Snappers at the time,
There was a lot of excitement around the Brewers. And then, but those guys at the height only got us so far. Well, we thought those guys were going to get to – World Series, and it just never really manifests itself. And the way I look at the Brewers right now, it just feels like it is hard for them to get there. Look at this season right now. The hope that you thought that you had your coach probably, dare I say, Craig Counsell may be the best skipper in Brewers history.
The way the Cubs paid him, I think you could believe that for sure.
Right? And then leave to go to the Cup. I mean, that's almost – unheard of. And then you look at the players that are hurt right now coming into this year, they really can never catch a break. So what are our hopes this year for the Brewers? Is it 80 wins? You hope a team like that with all the injuries that they have can get to 500.
Their win total projection was 77.5 wins, which I have a vested interest in betting the over from when I was in Iowa last week. So I definitely hope they get to 500 this year. I definitely have a personal interest in that occurring. 844-770-3776. Again, that's our ESPN Wisconsin talk and text line. Same number as usual, 844-770-3776. You can also weigh in the YouTube comments, on Twitter and Facebook, Wildy and Tausch, wherever you get us there watching along with the video stream. Have you lost interest in baseball over the last, we want to say 5 years, 10 years, maybe 5 years is a good metric, because that's kind of when the Brewers' wheelhouse has really opened up for playoff contention. Let's say the last 5 years. 844-770-3776. We've got that poll question shared from the Wildy and Tausch Twitter feed as well here coming up with today what was supposed to be Brewers opening day. That is now tomorrow. So we'll get all set for that more tomorrow. But we're talking baseball a little bit with you. When Jason and Tausch are gone, we get to do things like this. Plenty of Packers conversation still to come as well, including with our friend Evan Cohen of Unsportsmanlike on ESPN Radio. He is scheduled to appear coming up at the bottom of the hour, 9:30, about 12 minutes from right now. 844-770-3776. Jesse Nelson, Gary Ellerson, filling in as your cousin subs of the day on Wildy and Tausch. As we head to break, we do bring in Mark Tauscher from wherever he may be. I don't want to say the great beyond. He is still with us as far as I know. But he is here from a super undisclosed location to tell us all about Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin.
ESPN Wisconsin's Mark Tauscher here for Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. If you've been waiting to replace broken windows or doors, or you just want to revitalize your home with a new look, now is the time to get it done. Because from now until March 31st, you can get 0% interest for up to 3 years at Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. That's right. Pella now and pay later. 3 years later, in fact. Order by March 31st to get 0% interest for up to 3 years. Set your free consultation today at PellaWI.com. Certain restrictions do apply.
This is Wildy and Tausch, presented by Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. Call Gina Della from Pella today, 855-PELLA-WI, and online at PellaWI.com/radio.
To those who've ever dreamt of their perfect event, those dreams are worthy and they are possible. Hi, it's Jeffrey from Celebrations Entertainment. With hard work, passion, and great music, we will make your event dreams a reality. Every event is a labor of love, with one-on-one planning, customization, and flawless execution. Bringing your event to life is what we do. For a fun, memorable event, visit celebrationsentertainment.com. That's celebrationsentertainment.com.
When you're in the right place at the right time, things get done. The important things, like knowing what you need and how it all works, fixing it right the first time. At Zimbrick Chevrolet, our people get it done, right and now. That's how you know you're in the right place at the right time.
Lease a 2024 Chevrolet Silverado LT for $398 per month, or get up to $6,000 in savings on select models.
Never overpay at Zimbrick Chevrolet.
At Blaine's Farm and Fleet, we get you outdoors because we get you. Whether you're ready to work in the yard, tackle a project, or enjoy family time, we get you the right products at the right prices. Right now, rewards members get a free $10 Blaine's gift card with a $100 purchase of Estate Fertilizer. Men's and women's Carhartt pocket tees, 2 for $30. 15% off Gardner Bender electrical tools and supplies. And save $50 on select basement watchdog backup sump pump systems. We get you outdoors because we get you. At Blaine's Farm and Fleet.
UW Credit Union presents the Prep Mania Student Athlete of the Week, supporting local student athletes as they grow on the field, in the classroom, and in the community. UW Credit Union is here for every you. Learn more at uwcu.org. Here's Dennis Semra with the UW Credit Union Student Athlete of the Week.
Our ESPN Madison UW Credit Union Student Athlete of the Week, Tegan Mullaney. You started playing basketball, and when did you realize this might be the sport for me?
I think it was pretty early, like fourth grade. Yeah, my mom coached the JV team, so I'd come here after school, just like sharing that with her.
You're going to be going to Iowa next year.
Mm-hmm.
You had a lot of schools, pretty much coast to coast. What kind of went into your decision? You want to be a Hawkeye?
I think for me, it was just like the feeling I got when I was there and just the coaching staff in general. They're all women. It wasn't like make or break, but it was something that I thought was really cool.
You can tease it all about going out of state. You and Taylor Stremlo, you played together a little bit at AEU. You're both going to be Hawkeyes.
Yeah, I'm so excited. It was just like a goal for me to be able to play with her again. Just having this opportunity is really cool.
We all share the same roads, but when an accident happens, we don't always share the same consequences. Big trucks can cause big damage. Injuries can be severe and may require a lifetime of care and compensation. Call Gruber Law Offices today. We can help you from the safety and comfort of your own home. Our virtual sign-up process is quick and easy. Gruber Law Offices. One call, that's all.
Prize Picks is America's number one fantasy sports app with over 3 million active members. They are the easiest and most exciting way to play daily fantasy sports. All you do, pick more or less on a 2-6 player stat projection and watch the winnings roll in. Whether it's tournament season or the fight for playoff home court, there's no shortage of high stakes basketball moments this time of year. Prize Picks even offers injury insurance so that your entries stay in play even if one of your players gets hurt. For basketball games, if you have a player who exits the game in the first half and does not return in the second, Prize Picks will have your back and not count that as a loss. Prize Picks is really simple to play. I can make my picks and submit my entry in less than 60 seconds. Prize Picks also offers weekly promotions and special offers for the biggest moments in sports. Download the app today and use code WI for a first deposit match up to $100. That's code WI on Prize Picks for a deposit match up to $100. Pick more, pick less. It's that easy.
Like, share, and follow ESPN Madison everywhere. Follow us on Twitter, Instagram, Facebook, and TikTok for more great content from ESPN Madison. This is 100.5 ESPN and Wisconsin On Demand.
Is the day the Brewers almost played their first game of the 2024 regular season. Wildy and Tausch will always remember this as the day Jason and Tausch almost hosted the show together as well. Jesse Nelson, Gary Ellerson, your cousin subs of the day in for the fellas today, although Jason doesn't trust us quite enough yet, so he's going to stop by around 10:30. Evan Cohen of Unsportsmanlike on ESPN Radio scheduled to appear about 7 minutes from right now. 844-770-3776 is the ESPN Wisconsin talk and text line. And let's take a look at some of the responses coming in. So our poll question, which is now up on Twitter at Wildy and Tausch, I just know that Jason and Tausch, Gary, are going to give me a hard time for instantly getting this poll question posted once we came up with it hosting the show. Because they always say, Tausch comes up with 100 poll questions a day, and they say, how come that poll didn't get posted? Now I'm hosting the show right away. First thing, it's in the field.
It's there.
Yep. You know it. Got to take care of number one. Have you, whether you're a Brewers fan or not, have you lost interest in baseball over the last 5 years? Yes, I've lost interest, or no, still into it. Early in the voting, but it's a 50-50 split so far. Again, early into the voting. You can find that on Twitter, at Wildy and Tausch. Gary, you say that you have lost interest over the last 5 years because of what the Brewers have disappointed you by doing in the postseason.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And I think for me, they have come a long way, the organization, from when I first got into this business some 25 years ago. But I think when you get to a certain point, you have a certain standard, you kind of want your team so badly to get to the World Series. And they have been, Jesse, you talked about, they have just been knocking on the door, and they just have never been able to achieve that goal for one reason or another. And it just seems like now you've had the Diamondbacks, right? They've gotten into the World Series, and I don't know how that happened. I think the Washington Nationals have gotten there, but it just feel like it never works for the Brewers. I'm just doing the market size of what the Milwaukee Brewers are, Diamondbacks, you're looking at the Nationals. But we can never feel like get to that point to get into a World Series, which I think these fans deserve that. Give Mark Antanasio and his group a lot of credit. Give Craig Counsell and those guys a lot of credit to getting them to that point. But at some point as a fan, you like to see your team hosting a game at American Family Field, at one time Miller Park, hosting World Series game at their home field, because they work hard to get it. But to me, it's just an uphill battle, really, I think, over the last 10 years. I know you're saying five, but if you go back 10, it's still been a lot of disappointment for Brewer fans.
Yeah,
there's got to be a lot of people who feel the same way.
There are rolling in on the text line right now, 844-770-3776. I said 5 years, and that's because that's kind of been the wheelhouse of when the Brewers have been competing in the postseason, which I think is right. One of the fascinating metrics of this. If you go back 10 years, that would be like when the last time the Brewers really went through a rebuild, that 2015 kind of range when they kind of, at the trade deadline, they sold a bunch of players off and then kind of reset the operation, and then a couple of years later acquired Yelich and Lorenzo Cain and made the big run at it. Some of the responses coming in on the text line. Dave and Aaron, I agree with Gary. Usually the best way to get a text onto the show is saying, I agree with Tausch. Now we've got a new one. I agree with Gary. I'm always excited, but it is always a letdown by the end of the year. Dave and Aaron shares that on the text line. Text from a 920 number. Remember, if you're just texting us for one of the first times, make sure you say who you are and where you're texting from so we can give you proper citation. 920 says, all the teams in Wisconsin, I feel, are that way since the Badgers lost to Duke in the NCAA tournament. The Bucks were the only odd one out, but once they won, I felt like it was a weight off their shoulders, and now it's like, well, you won one, so what's next? That's from a 920. Sean on YouTube, as you see on the live video stream on YouTube, Twitter, and Facebook. Could be worse. Could be a White Sox fan like me.
Could
that
be.
Is true.
Could be.
I have a bunch of friends I went to college with who are White Sox fans who were excited for a potential 35-win season this year. One of the worst teams that may ever take the field in Major League Baseball. Some of the other responses. Jeff in Monroe is a big fan of the show, Gary, and he's a big Brewers fan when he plays trivia and when he chimes in on other topics. Jeff says, still all in on the Brewers. Interested in seeing if Pat Murphy can get them over the hump. How many casual fans, how many casual Wisconsin sports fans do you think could even name who the manager of the Milwaukee Brewers is right now?
Not very many outside of Wisconsin.
Yeah, that's fascinating.
And Pat Murphy has been around in this game for a long, long time.
Right. Yeah.
But I mean, if you step up, he's not a new guy. But if you step outside of Wisconsin, I don't think very many people can name the manager. And we kind of know what it is. It's really Pat Murphy, but it's really Ricky Weeks' job that's standing there and waiting. I think that's how that's going to pan out. But so. It's very interesting when they hired Pat Murphy, and he deserves a job, don't get me wrong, but I feel like it's probably going to be Ricky Weeks' job at some point.
That seems to be what they have in place there, which is just so crazy to me, thinking about Ricky Weeks coming up, like making his major league debut, and how dialed in I was watching that game. Now, oh, he's the manager in waiting for the Milwaukee Brewers. This is what it feels like when you get to this certain stage of life. Huh. 844-770-3776. Continue to keep your texts coming in. There's plenty more that we can get to as the show continues, but we're going to step aside right now because on the other side, Evan Cohen, our friend from Unsportsmanlike on ESPN Radio, is scheduled to appear. Normally, Gary, when he comes on the show, Tausch is ready for a fight with him. He loves getting into some solid debates with Evan. I don't know what the dynamic's going to be like. I'm probably going to have to try and take the place of Tausch and get into something with Evan, and here's what I'll tell you. Evan called me the other day, and it was a feeling of dread the second that I saw his name show up on the phone. I will tell him, you, and everyone about that situation when we come back. Right. Evan Cohen of Unsportsmanlike, scheduled to appear next. With Jesse and Gary, it's Wilde and Tausch. Spins his way into the paint with contact, finishes, and a foul.
That was pretty.
To the pros.
Beverly launches from three, and he knocks it down.
The biggest games play on 100.5 ESPN.
Get 0% interest for up to 3 years at Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. I'm Gina Della from Pella. Pella's free in-home consultations make replacing or redesigning your windows and doors easy. We go beyond just measuring and handing you a quote by listening and educating you on all of your product options. And with DesignWorks, you can see what your home will look like before you buy. Order by March 31st to get 0% interest for up to 3 years. Set your free consultation at PellaWI.com.
Certain restrictions apply.
Panic strikes as you realize on Wednesday that Thursday is your anniversary. The reservations? Being secured.
We'll see you at 8.
The gift? Being purchased. Yeah, you've got this. Just like Associated Bank's got you with early pay up to 2 days early on direct deposits. So even though they call you last minute Lisa, we'll make your last minute scrambling a bit easier. You've got this with early pay from Associated Bank. See associatedbank.com/checking or ask a banker for details. Member FDIC.
Mark Tauscher here for Chalmers Jewelers. I've been a big fan of Scott and Garrett and the whole team at Chalmers Jewelers for years now. I go there, my friends go there, and most importantly, my wife loves it whenever I get her something from Chalmers Jewelers. What's right around the corner? Mother's Day. Show some love to the incredible women in your life and stop at Chalmers Jewelers, the place to go for that perfect gift. I recommend Chalmers Jewelers in Middleton and Madison.
Chalmers Jewelers in Middleton
and Madison.
Hey, it's Hunter Vaughn. ESPN Madison and Zimbrick Honda are celebrating the area's best high school sports stories with the Game Changers of the Month. Follow ESPN Madison on social media to see teams making an impact in their community. Nominate your local team today at ESPNMadisonGameChangers.com.
Ben Brust here to tell you about the Princeton Club. I joined the Princeton Club because I was looking for a place I could invest in my health, and the environment and the community I have felt has made it so easy for me to incorporate it into my everyday life. It doesn't matter where you're at in your fitness journey, because they have something to offer everyone. It also goes beyond fitness. From the moment you walk in the club to the moment you walk out, there is a togetherness felt throughout the members and staff that keeps you going for your better tomorrow. Don't wait any longer and get started on your fitness journey today at PrincetonClub.net. That's PrincetonClub.net.
Cousin Subs was founded in Milwaukee, Wisconsin in 1972 and has been a member of the Madison community for decades. This year, Cousins has expanded their footprint in the Madison area by opening new locations in Stoughton and Sun Prairie, in addition to existing locations on East Washington Avenue, Monona, and Lodi. Order your favorite subs online or via our app for delivery or pickup. Eat in or grab them to go through our drive-thru for a better sub experience. Cousin Subs, we believe in better.
Stoughton Health, in collaboration with patient and family advisors, seeks to advance the healthcare experience at Stoughton Health by providing a forum for past patients and families to provide feedback on a variety of healthcare and other related topics. Advisors offer constructive feedback on their personal journey at Stoughton Health, helping to elevate the patient experience and increase satisfaction. Interested? Please call Amy at 608-873-2308.
Since 1956, Holman Lindsay Paints has been making paint in Wisconsin for Wisconsin. Because of their commitment to making great paint for Wisconsinites, Holman Lindsay has grown over the years to 26 locations in this great state. Headquarters in Sun Prairie with a state-of-the-art facility, Holman Lindsay has the paints you need to make your job better. From do-it-yourself to professional, Holman Lindsay has paint for everyone. Visit one of their local locations today in Madison, Sun Prairie, Middleton, and Janesville.
For official rules and more information about every contest on 100.5 ESPN, visit ESPNWisconsinContest.com. That's ESPNWisconsinContest.com. You're listening to 100.5 ESPN and the ESPN app.
On the air, on demand, on social, on Wisconsin sports. Serving Wisconsin sports fans, this is 100.5 ESPN. I'm throwing cold.
Jesse Nelson, Gary Ellerson, your cousin subs of the day in for Wildy and Tausch. So I was sitting in the sports book in Dubuque, Iowa on Friday. Front row, big blue comfy seat, Coors Light in hand, watching Baylor and Colgate, hoping to death that my Patriots would finally get over the hump and win for the first time in 5 years. Didn't happen. Not going well, and then I look down and I see that I missed a phone call from Evan Cohen, host of Unsportsmanlike, weekday mornings, 5 to 9 a.m. on ESPN Radio. And I had this immediate moment of panic. Like, oh no, what happened? What did I forget to do? This is going to be horrible. Instantly, just fear. I get up. Run to the other side of the place, find a quiet spot to call him back. And it was just something that had come up at lunch with him and Matt LaPay while they were in Brooklyn together. Just wanted to talk it over. But just dread and panic. And with that, we bring in the host of Unsportsmanlike, weekday mornings, 5 to 9 a.m. on ESPN Radio. It's Evan Cohen. Evan, good morning. Thanks for joining Gary and I. I'm not as scared to you today.
What an intro. You know what's amazing, Jesse? Now that I think about this, and Gary, I'm glad that Jesse reminded me of this. What I asked Jesse for, he actually still hasn't done.
Yeah, I have not delivered. I have not delivered on that yet. Yep, coming soon.
That is an amazing thing, because I've known Jesse for a long time. I guess, obviously, he's still afraid of me, which is wonderful. It's really heartwarming. Gary and I have had many conversations. We've had wonderful, positive, honest, back-and-forth conversations. And for some reason, Jesse Nelson brings this up, only to give the audience the indication that I am scary, yet actually throws himself under the bus because I asked him for a simple task that is yet to not be completed of literally, hey, something cool happened on your show. I'd love it to send to someone. And you still haven't done that.
We'll get there. Now I am scared.
Gary, now he should be scared now that I think about it.
No, he should be. He threw himself under the bus. I've never seen that before.
Exactly. Yeah, that was an interesting move. I don't think that was his intention, but that is exactly what just happened.
But now I know what it's like for when Tausch is in this seat and that happens to him when he's talking to you all the time. Jesse Nelson with Scary and Gary with you here on Wildy and Tausch.
Oh, my God. Wow.
So, Evan, we've been talking baseball, believe it or not, to start. This is what happens when Jason and Tausch are gone. Gary and I get to take over the show. We've been talking baseball because our Twitter poll question, with the returns coming back about the way we had expected so far, have you, whether you're a Brewers fan or not, lost interest in baseball over the last 5 years in celebration of opening day or what would have been for the Brewers against the New York Mets here today? Evan, would you say you have lost interest in baseball over the last 5 years?
Yeah, it's amazing, guys. When I was growing up, and I'm from New York originally, then went to the University of Wisconsin, and when I grew up, the Major League Baseball was by far my favorite sport. The two things that I loved, for whatever reason, Major League Baseball and NCAA men's basketball. And now, today, we have NCAA men's basketball and Major League Baseball, and I'm more interested in the NFL draft, stories around Caitlin Clark, and anything NBA, Draymond Green, or whatever you want to throw out there. I have totally lost interest in it, and I have two theories as to non-personal, like meaning my grandfather, may he rest in peace, was a huge baseball fan, and that was our connection, amongst other things. But I have two theories, kind of the same theory with two teams, as to why the masses may have lost some interest. This may sound crazy, but I want to run them by you. I think the Red Sox and the Cubs winning actually has hurt baseball, because baseball forever had evil empire with the Yankees and lovable losers, maybe for people outside of Milwaukee, but with the Cubs and the Red Sox, and we don't have that anymore. There's no national attachment to it. I've totally lost interest.
And Gary, you said you've lost interest for a different reason.
Well, yeah, I would say with my home team, the Brewers here, for me, it just seems like they can never get over a hump, right? They can never get into the World Series, no matter how hard they try. I think with the revenue sharing, that's always going to be tough for a small market team like the Milwaukee Brewers to get there. Now, there have been some other teams, right? The Diamondbacks have been able to get there, the Nationals. But I think for the most part, when you look at what the Brewers have been able to do, it's been remarkable. But you still feel like that they're climbing uphill, that you still feel like they're trying to catch lightning in a bottle. It's got to be perfect. When you're probably the best manager in Brewers history, I would probably say Craig Counsell, when he leaves just to go up the street, because really I think it was about money and you couldn't pay him, speaks loudly of really where the Brewers are as far as a organization is concerned.
So, Gary, let me ask you a question about the team that you played for in the NFL, the Green Bay Packers, versus the Brewers for a second. Are you telling me and everyone that basically your mindset is, if the Packers find someone, either a coach or a player, that they develop, your assumption at this point is they're going to find a way to keep them? Is your assumption now, if the Brewers find someone, that they're going to find a way to not keep them? Is that kind of where your mindset is right now?
Absolutely. Not keep them or they get hurt. I.e. Christian Yelich, right? I think guys get to a certain point in a contract where you know that they can't pay them. You know they got to trade them off. You know it. We saw it happen with Prince Fielder some years back. You can see the writing on the wall that they're not going to be able to retain these players and pay them.
And then as you sit here with Jordan Love, your assumption is if they have to make him the highest paid player in the sport, they're going to do that if he warrants that contract after this year.
They will for the next 10 years. They'll pay him all the money, just like they did with Brett Favre, just like they did with Aaron Rodgers. And then expect the expected, and that will be, when he gets to be about, 35 or 36, they see the writing on the wall. Guess what? They're going to let him go.
Yeah, I tend to agree with you with the Packers. That you guys know more about the Brewers than I do. Boy, Jesse, what a change of pace talking to a former Badger/Packer that has reasoning and thoughts that make some sense. I'm not used to that on this show.
That'll happen.
Oh, snap.
That'll happen when Gary Ellerson's filling it around here. Jesse Nelson, Gary Ellerson with Evan Cohn of Unsportsmanlike on ESPN Radio. Now, I do feel like I need to take the place of Tausch here a little bit, Evan, because you don't come around here just to agree with everybody. You come around here to kind of get after it a little bit. And since we've already started that on the page of me being scared by you the other day, I want to play something that Mike McCarthy said at the NFL meetings earlier this week. And then I want you to say what you said on Unsportsmanlike this week about what McCarthy said. Here is Mike McCarthy earlier this week.
Well, I have a lot of experience in not being active in veteran free agency, so I guess doesn't bother me as much. But, no, I think it's like anything, and it really is. I mean, you're working on your roster 365 days a year, and that's always been a reality. And I think as a coach, I've really always focused on the guys I know are going to be there in the offseason program because, you know, you really do have a chance to improve as a football team. You know, I'm a big believer in a second- and third-year jump. You know, we have some young players. We got some guys coming back off of IR that were young players that we're excited about. So we are definitely improving. You know, we're just not part of the free agent market right now.
Did you ever think, Evan, you would hear Mike McCarthy say that his Dallas Cowboys are less active in free agency than the Green Bay Packers?
Jesse, what's the point of me saying it if you're going to say what I said?
I'm asking you to elaborate on it.
You played the sound from the interview that McCarthy did with Schefter saying, hey, and it was a good setup because I knew where you were going with it, but then you gave my entire point. I don't have much else to add now. My whole point was going to be it was a backhanded shot at the Packers, him saying, hey, I'm used to a team not going all in, even though the Cowboys' mantra has been all in, because I was the coach of the Packers for a decade. A really successful coach, might I add, as someone that supports Mike McCarthy, as you know. But, yeah, that was my whole point. So now you want Gary to react to me reacting to you, reacting to Mike McCarthy reacting to me. Great. Great setup, Jesse. Well done.
Gary, what you think?
I mean, seriously.
Yeah, I'm lost for words, actually. But how about this?
Well, Jesse? Okay, so let me do the. I'm going to reverse it, Gary, since Jesse doesn't know how to do
it. Jeez.
Do you think that Mike McCarthy was taking a shot at the Packers when he said to Schefter, I'm used to working in an environment where veteran free agency is not a thing?
Well, it's obvious that he was, but I would like to say this. I think, though, the Packers, and I think you look at the Cowboys right now, they're a product of their system, is that they have drafted very well. And now the players that they drafted are coming due, and they're going to have to pay them. I have always looked at free agency with the Green Bay Packers in that they have to sign their own players to big money contracts because they drafted very well. And I think that's what you are seeing right now with the Dallas Cowboys. They have drafted very well, and now these contracts are coming due all at one time, and there's no money left to go into free agency. They paid Dak Prescott a lot of money, and now he's going to sit there this year to try to approve a deal. I don't know how that's going to work out for them, but I think they're a product of being well or drafting well, and I think the Packers are in the same boat. Now, you don't have Aaron Rodgers anymore, David Bakhtiari. They have some opportunity to go spend some money, and that's what we're seeing right now with the Packers, that they're starting all over again because most of their players are now on rookie contracts or where they can go out and get some players.
For sure, but the Packers this offseason did things, obviously, specifically with Josh Jacobs and Xavier McKinney, of two players running back and safety that they don't normally do, right? Like, they went about this in a way that Mike McCarthy, as a Packer head coach, and obviously now as a Cowboys head coach, not used to. Like, that is awkward to a point that I know in Milwaukee, Jen Gabe and Chewy, Gabe Neitzel, in the show the week of free agency and I remember talking to Gabe and he said, well, this is not a week they normally do anything. This is normally a dead week. And so McCarthy has now had to deal with this for almost the entirety of his career, playing with coaching for two of the most historic franchises in this sport, knowing we're not going to get guys by way of free agency. But as you said, there's an yin and a yang with this, Gary, because both of those teams are very good at drafting.
And I think that's a product of, really, I think both organizations, they kind of mirror themselves. The Pittsburgh Steelers, I believe, they're kind of in the same situation. They're like that too, but when they lost Big Ben, they were able to have some money to go spend. But I think when you look at a lot of teams in the NFL, it's really not about a quick fix. Don't get me wrong. I like Xavier McKinney. I like what they were able to do to go get Josh Jacobs. And they got the two best free agents that are out there at their positions, which bodes well for the Green Bay Packers. Not only that, they even got younger when they went and made those two moves. So I think the future is bright. The Packers still have a lot of money left. I will say this, though, Evan, if Aaron Rodgers was still the quarterback of the Green Bay Packers, and if David Bakhtiari was still here, I don't think they would have the money to go sign Jacobs or Xavier McKinney.
And I think that's why you have to take advantage of what they're doing right now, which is as long as you have Jordan Love on kind of the, I don't even know how to describe it, the fake fifth-year option, right? Because it wasn't the full fifth-year option, the add-on at a lower cost. As long as you have him on that, you have to supplement the rest of the roster with higher-priced guys that maybe in a year, 2 years, 3 years, you will not be able to do. And maybe ultimately that does cost them some of the draft and development guys. They cannot re-sign some of their own, and they just trust their process in that, okay, so player X is up in free agency. We know that's going to happen after 2025, so let's draft that same position this year to get us ready for that. But that's the advantage of having the quarterback on a rookie scale deal, which obviously they have.
Part of Evan Cohen's universal laws of having a quarterback, or however that came up on Greeny that you blew us off for a couple of weeks ago.
Yeah.
Evan Cohen of Unsportsmanlike on ESPN Radio joining us on Wilde and Tausch, Jesse Nelson, Gary Ellerson. Evan, what does all in look like in the National Football League? If we're saying the Packers were never truly all in under Ted Thompson, the late Ted Thompson, and the Cowboys aren't all in, even though Jerry Jones is saying that's what they're going to, what does all in look like?
Okay, you just brought up something really interesting. We know that the Cowboys, you can't spin it if you're the Dallas Cowboys that this offseason you've gone all in. But that's an interesting question. I don't know who wrote that for you, Jesse, but that was good. Relative to the Packers retroactively. Because they won a Super Bowl and were always competitive in terms of contending for another. Did they go all in or did they not go all in? Like, looking back at the Aaron Rodgers era of the Green Bay Packers, did they go all in your mind?
I would say yes, the Packers went all in. Gary, would you agree?
Yeah, I would. I think if you even go back to the Smith brothers when they brought them in, he totally revamped that defense when they needed a lot of players. I mean, Julius Peppers was a really good signing when they did that. So, yeah, I think they've done as well as they could with the money that they had.
So I think in terms of the Green Bay Packers, all in for them at that time was probably taking care of their own by re-signing a lot of their draft picks, as we've been discussing, and supplementing probably with second-tier free agency versus top-tier free agency. So I would probably say they went in per their version of all in. I would not say they went all in per, like, the Philadelphia Eagles version of all in.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think all in looks different to different teams. Like, when Julius Peppers or Charles Woodson were signed by the Packers back in the day. Like,
that's all in. For them, that's all in.
For sure that's all in, right. Yeah. And just because they don't need to add four more veteran free agents to say we're going all in, like, that's a credit to the drafting and the scouting and the whole development of the roster.
And the other thing is, the Green Bay Packers, like, for the majority of my life, have had a first ballot Hall of Fame quarterback. So not many other franchises can say that. And thus, as you said, the different teams have different versions of all in. All in, when you're paying a quarterback top dollar because he can outperform that contract, part of my QB rules, thanks for bringing that up, Jesse. Yes, many people at ESPN now starting to use those because they're really brilliant. Throw more touchdowns than interceptions. But, like, I think that because they have always had that, they've never had to break one of my QB rules, which is to pay wide receivers to make quarterbacks better. They've always been able to pay the quarterbacks to make everybody else better.
Makes total sense.
Absolutely.
Evan, from your national perspective, when you look around the league, who's all in right now? How many teams would you say in the NFL right now are all in for 2024?
I think the Chiefs, obviously.
Yeah.
I think the Eagles are. I think the Niners are, even though they've had to, you know, make some moves here and pretend, you know, they still haven't worked the Brandon Ayuk contract. I can't say the Cowboys are. You know what? I think the Packers may be. Because if you think about what they've done, like, and I know that, what's going to happen here is the Jordan Love contract extension will happen at some point. But I think the Packers are probably closer to being all in. I think the Lions are, oddly enough.
Yeah.
I don't know that, they're going to be as great as maybe everyone else thinks they are. Dare I say the Bears are? You know, they're going to take the number one pick. They're not going to kick it down the line at all. They've spent tons of money on their defense and skill position players. I'm probably missing a bunch, but those are some names that I would give you.
That's fascinating that you would say the Bears are all in, even though they hold the number one overall pick in the upcoming draft.
Well, how are they not? How are they not? DJ Moore, Keenan Allen, DeAndre Swift, so that's massive upgrades at skill positions. Mm-hmm. They have, correct me if I'm wrong, they have two first-round or high-round tackles. They trade for Montez Sweat, a second-round pick last year. They extend on the defense. They have given big monies to a secondary player, a linebacker, and a defensive lineman. And they're going to draft Caleb Williams number one overall. The only thing, there's two items that I would say the Bears should still do, in my opinion. Number one, I think they should sign Ryan Tannehill to be their backup quarterback. And number two, I think they should give Matt Eberflus, their head coach, an extension, which people may sit there and say, well, good, if you're a Packers fan, you want that guy there? Gary knows this better than we would. Like, the last thing you need with a rookie quarterback is to play for multiple coaches in multiple years. So if you're going to keep Eberflus, you've got to extend him, and you got to keep him there or get rid of him now. Like, that's the beauty for Jordan Love. There is nothing that would make any of us think that Jordan Love, for the first 5 to 10 years of his career, will not play for the same head coach every single year.
That's absolutely right. Question I have for you, Evan, real quick, is the structure of the Green Bay Packers. Now, we talked a little bit about this yesterday, where I think Matt LaFleur came out and said something to the fact of that he was not aware that the Packers were letting Aaron Jones go and signing Josh Jacobs. And to me, I think that is a little bit of a head scratcher for your head coach not to know what's going on, where Brian Gutekunst did not tell him that these things were happening. Isn't that a little bit of a head scratcher for you on how they do business within an organization?
Yeah, that's I did not realize that. That's an interesting point. I will say this. I'm glad he's not on so I can say this about him. I absolutely, from the get-go, have agreed with Tausch on Brian Gutekunst has done so many things right that he deserves the benefit of the doubt with everything. So I am going to spin it in a way, Gary. I may be wrong, but I'm going to spin it in a way of he wanted no blood on the coach's hands if Aaron Jones was either not back or had to take a pay cut to come back. That maybe, I know, Gary, you're involved in many businesses and involved in leadership. Like, maybe that's a leader taking charge and saying, I want to protect someone that I'm working with from being the bad guy. And so maybe it was, I'm going to have ignorance for my head coach, so he's never going to be looked at as the bad guy, just in case Aaron Jones comes back and that number goes from $12 million to $5 million, and he may come back in a bitter sort of way, and then look at the head coach and say, well, why didn't you want me? And the head coach would then have plausible deniability of, I did. I didn't know this was happening.
So you're saying that then you like the structure then of the Green Bay Packers and the way that they do business that way, that they keep the head coach separate from the money issues.
Well, there's a difference. Is it the money issue? I mean, you tell me, is it the money issue or is it the personnel issues, right? Like, I'm not a believer that the general manager should interact daily with the players. I think that's the coach's issue. I think, fortunately, the general manager's job is to be a little bit inhumane, so to speak, in that every single player is, this is number 10, he plays quarterback, here's what I pay him, here's what he produces, and it's my job to evaluate it. It's the coach's job to have the personal relationships with the players. So I don't know. Is that, you tell me, is that the way that they operate? Because I am okay if that is the way that they operate, because the moment the general manager has a relationship with the player and the player says to the general manager, because they have a relationship, Are you going to cut me? Are you going to trade me? All that leads you into is voluntarily lying to someone, which why would you want to do that?
Right, and you're right, and because that's the reason why they had to make the move with Mike Sherman. I think that was Mike Sherman's downfall when he was the head coach and general manager. That it just got in the way of now he's got to deal with the contracts and he's got to be the head coach. And he really couldn't be honest with the guys that he was trying to negotiate with and then be their coach. And I think there were a butting of heads with that. And I think when you look at now the Packers, the way the structure is, the way you explain it, yes, I do agree with you. But at some point, it just made me feel a little uneasy when he wasn't privy to any information regarding Aaron Jones.
Yeah, and I don't know the full-fledged version of that story, obviously, like you guys do. But I'll give you a weird example. Do you remember when the Toronto Raptors traded longtime player DeMar DeRozan for Kawhi Leonard?
Yes.
And there was a big story about how Masai Ujiri, the general manager of the Raptors, was asked by DeMar DeRozan, are you going to trade me? He said no, and then he got offered Kawhi Leonard, and of course he traded him, right? And so, like, I would say to players, anyone that would ask if I was a general manager, if they said, will you cut me? Would you trade me? My response would be, what is your name? And then the person would say, Gary Ellerson. and then I would say, so your name is not Patrick Mahomes, correct? No, it's not. And yes, there's always a chance I could trade or cut you. Right, and that's honestly, that's how I yeah. It's harsh, but that's kind of how you have to answer. Yeah. Right? Like, hey, Wilby and Tausch, could Karma Brands get rid of you? Is your name Howard Stern? No. Well, then yes. Then there's always a chance, right? I mean, like, that's the reality we live in. Like, oh, could I get fired from unsportsmanlike of ESPN? My name ain't Stephen A. Smith, so the answer is yes at any given point.
Evan, I'll get you your I Agree with Tausch shirt in the mail. That'll come right along with the other thing that
just
I need to get.
Get me the clip that I need, Jesse. It's been 2 weeks.
We'll get both of those, and I look forward to your next phone call. Thank you so much for joining us today. Appreciate it.
Hey, guys. Thank you. Thanks.
Evan Cohen, buddy. Unsportsmanlike on ESPN Radio, joining us this morning. We'll dissect some of what he said, including perhaps Hunter Vaughn, our resident Cowboys fan here at ESPN Wisconsin, can get his Cowboys minute in response to what Evan was saying about them going all in this year in free agency. That's coming up next. Wilde and Tausch, Jesse and Gary, ESPN Wisconsin.
Like, share, and follow ESPN Madison everywhere. Follow us on Twitter, Instagram, Facebook, and TikTok for more great content from ESPN Madison. This is 100.5 ESPN and Wisconsin On Demand. Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin present your Badger Minute. Here's Alex Strofe.
This Badger Minute brought to you by your Badgerland Chevy dealers, proud supporters of Badger Athletics. Go to badgerlandchevy.com.
Longtime Wisconsin State Journal columnist Jim Polzine joined Kyle Bruston-Nortman on ESPN Wisconsin earlier this week and compared the current state of men's basketball coach Greg Gard to former football coach Paul Christ's hot seat and what it would take to move on from Gard.
I didn't think Chris McIntosh would fire Paul Christ, but again, something in that two-hour conversation changed Chris McIntosh's mind, and I think it would take a similar conversation with Greg Gard probably to get him to the point where he's ready to move on and find someone new.
Find the full conversation with Jim Polzine on Wisconsin On Demand or wherever you get your podcasts.
Get no interest for up to 3 years at Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. Don't wait. You have to order by March 31st. Visit PellaWI.com.
Ben Brust here to tell you about why your next work van should be from Mercedes-Benz Sprinter at Zimbrick European. First off, we have versatility. The Sprinter vans offer 16 body types and thousands of ways to customize that space. Number two, we have reliability. Sprinter's most powerful diesel engines last longer and require less maintenance, spend more time in the road, and less time in those bays. Number three, we have safety. Sprinter's safety technologies include curtain airbags all around, load adaptive electronic stability program, and crosswind and attention assist. Number four, Van Care Mobile. Our maintenance team can come to you with routine service. Who wants to go in? Let them come to you. They work with multiple trucks on one visit. Use the Mercedes Me Connect. And last but not least, get your Zimbrick Sprinter at Zimbrick European at Rimrock Road and the Beltline, or go online at ZimbrickEuropean.com, because they never charge over the MSRP.
Price! Prize Picks is America's number one fantasy sports app with over 3 million active members. They are the easiest and most exciting way to play daily fantasy sports. All you do, pick more or less on a 2-6 player stat projection and watch the winnings roll in. Whether it's tournament season or the fight for playoff home court, there's no shortage of high-stakes basketball moments this time of year. Prize Picks even offers injury insurance so that your entries stay in play even if one of your players gets hurt. For basketball games, if you have a player who exits the game in the first half and does not return in the second, Prize Picks will have your back and not count that as a loss. Prize Picks is really simple to play. I can make my picks and submit my entry in less than 60 seconds. Prize Picks also offers weekly promotions and special offers for the biggest moments in sports. Download the app today and use code WI for a first deposit match up to $100. That's code WI on Prize Picks for a deposit match up to $100. Pick more, pick less. It's that easy.
From the biggest plays on the court to the comments made in the locker room after, an in-depth recap of every Bucks game in 6 minutes. No more, no less. Bucks in Six provides game recaps for every game. Hear the high-flying dunks from Giannis.
Puts it on the floor, spins down the lane, and plunges it through.
Or the deep threes from Dame.
Dame time has arrived with 107.
Bucks in Six on the Bucks Plus Audio Network. Find it now on Bucks.com/plus or on Spotify, Apple, and wherever you get your podcasts.
At Starion Bank, they pride themselves on being a super community bank. Small enough to show they care about you and the communities they serve, while being large enough to make big things happen. With 3 Madison area branches in Middleton, Sun Prairie, and Monona, Starion Bank is here investing in your community while offering valuable personal and business banking services. Start your experience with Starion Bank today by going to StarionBank.com. Member FDIC.
Wilthy and Tausch on 100.5 ESPN is brought to you by Everlight Solar. Save money, save the planet. Everlight Solar.
Give me one reason to steer, and I'll turn right back around.
Give me one reason. Wilthy and Tausch, Jesse Nelson, Gary Ellerson, your cousin subs of the day with Jason and Tausch both on assignment, although Jason is scheduled to appear coming up around 10:30 here this morning. Should probably check with him, see if he's still in for that or not. Just thought of that. Coming to
never
mind.
Know.
Yeah, I guess.
Yeah. Plans, he's got a lot going on, you know.
Plans change around here on a whim, you know that. 844-770-3776 is the number to get into the show. Special thanks again to Evan Cohen of Unsportsmanlike ESPN Radio for joining us last segment. Hunter Vaughn is our cousin sub of the day producing today's show, because if I'm hosting the show, someone's got to produce it. That's Hunter. Hunter is our resident Cowboys fan. So, Hunter, as you hear Evan Cohen talking about the Dallas Cowboys and the fact that Jerry Jones keeps saying they're all in, but Mike McCarthy's comparing them to the Ted Thompson-led Packers of the mid-2000s. How are you feeling as a Cowboys fan this offseason?
I'm incredibly frustrated because Jerry's created this for himself. If you think back about the Cowboys, like the year they drafted Dez Bryant in the first round, they just before that traded for Roy Williams, the wide receiver from the Lions, and he was garbage. Jerry had this history at that time of going terrible contracts, trading for guys who had no business trading for, to quote, go all in. And then they had cap hell for years and had to defer money, and he overpaid Tony Romo at times, and it was just a mess. So now he's gone the complete opposite way because he's terrified of putting his team in that situation again. So now they're all in is, well, we're just going to re-sign the guys we drafted and just get ourselves under the cap, and maybe we'll get a 35-year-old D-tackle who plays like 5 snaps, and then, oh, see, we brought somebody in. And I'm just – I can't win with that team. He can't find the happy medium, and I just get to deal with whatever it is, and I keep coming back with my Stockholm syndrome.
Well, no, I think what you have to look at is that their drafting has just been so much better than it has been in years past. I mean, who was the defensive back that blew his knee? To me, that was a generational player that they had. And you've got to pay him money. I think you look at the linebacker that they have that's really good. You've got to pay him money. Dak Prescott is really good. You got to pay him. So I think what you have to look at is they've done very well at shifting how they do business and drafting guys that they need to retain that are relatively young, where you really cannot afford to go out and get any big-name free agents. I mean, that's the way the Pittsburgh Steelers have done business to in the years past. I think you see these organizations, that's why they've been so successful. And Evan's right. You look at the Philadelphia Eagles right now, I think a long time ago, didn't they go all in and had like this dream team
yeah.
that they went and got?
Mm-hmm. That's who I thought anything. Of right away when he said it.
Didn't get them anything. And so I think the business model, to me, if you can do it, draft well, pay your own players, and then kind of go in behind that and build up behind it like the Packers have done in years past and like the Steelers have done in years past.
Hunter,
I don't think it's a bad thing, Hunter.
Has Gary calmed you down at all? Or
a little there? Bit, but the problem is I saw the LA Rams win a Super Bowl by doing kind of the opposite. And that's why I'm like, well, they can do it. And I'm like, they've already, the Cowboys already have the five rings. Like, I can, I'm okay with like, oh, okay, let's have some crap years. If I can just get that one ring again and I'll be good for another 30 years because that's what I've already had to deal with. So just give me that one to hold me off for another 30.
I wonder how many Packers.
No, you're right. That Rams team was an anomaly on that. They went out and get some players. I think, was that the move? Was that the Jared Goff move?
When they traded Goff for Stafford, and then Stafford came in and won it for him. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yep.
So then who was the other person that they went and got that year? Was that OBJ?
Yes, OBJ hurt? And Jalen Ramsey they brought over from Jacksonville.
That's right. Yeah, Ramsey was part of that too.
Right.
Yep. More than one way to try and win it. The Packers have shown us that over the decades, but we'll see if they can get over the hump just like the Cowboys and some of those other teams around the National Football League, and just like the Milwaukee Brewers, who get started with opening day tomorrow in New York City against the Mets. 10 o'clock hour of Will Dean Tausch starts in 2 minutes, and how nice of Jason and Tausch. I put this on the show sheet the other day. They said, let's let Jesse and Gary take care of that when they host together later this week. Power rankings, post-free agency, my favorite. We'll do it in 2 minutes to start the 10 Love o'clock it. Hour of Wildy and Tausch.
Anywhere. Another hour of Wildy and Tausch, presented by Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin, is coming up next on ESPN Wisconsin, the ESPN app, and Wisconsin On Demand.
Mark Tauscher here, and when I was on the hunt for a hot tub, I found Patio Pleasures, a locally owned family business. Patio Pleasures has a passion for making your home a place for recovery and relaxation. And that's why I'm excited about my new cold plunge from Patio Pleasures. They only showcase premium recovery and relaxation products, and that's how I know it's going to be great. Gear up for spring and check out Patio Pleasures' two incredible showrooms, Madison West and Sun Prairie.
Hi, this is Dave Kane. You're listening to Madison's Home of the Bucks, a Good Karma brand radio station, 100.5 ESPN WTLX Monona, Madison.
Broadcasting live from the Everlight Solar Studio, this is your Metro Kia of Madison Sports Center.
What is up, Madison? I'm Hunter Vaughn. Your Sports Center update is brought to you by Goodman's Jewelers, the diamond store of Madison for generations. Check them out at 220 State Street and online at goodmansjewelers.com. Well, today was supposed to be the season opener for the Milwaukee Brewers as they are at the New York Mets, but due to rain, that game's been postponed to tomorrow for a 12:40 first pitch. The Brewers will play three games at the Mets before they return to Milwaukee for their home opener on Tuesday against the Minnesota Twins for a 3:10 first pitch in that one. In college hoops, the Wisconsin women's basketball team is hosting Illinois State in the Super 16 of the WNIT tournament tonight at the Kohl Center. Tip-off for that one is at 6 p.m. The winner plays either IPFW or St. Louis in the Great Eight. And then in men's college basketball, the Marquette Golden Eagles, they're getting ready to play in the Sweet 16 against 11 seed NC State on Friday. 6:09 is opening tip for that one. The Golden Eagles are 6.5-point favorites.
Metro Kia of Madison, Madison's trusted Kia dealer. Stop into Metro Kia on the east side of Madison or MetroKiaOfMadison.com.
Yeah.
of Wildy and Tausch with no Wildy and no Tausch. Or is there? Wait just a minute. Jason Wildy has confirmed he's happy to join us at 10:30 this morning. So if you're looking for your Wildy fix, he will be on with us about 20 minutes from right now. So Gary, don't worry. I hope he approves of how we've handled the responsibilities of keeping the house clean while he and Tausch have been away here.
Well, if I say so, no beer drinking yet, right?
Not yet. Yeah, Coors Light is nearby.
Yeah, no loud parties. No one's called the police on us yet. So far, so good.
A-plus effort so far on our part. 844.
Can I tell you a quick story? I got a story.
Please do, Gary. Please do.
So my wife and I, we go out of town years back. And with my daughter, my middle daughter, she had a basketball tournament up in Wausau. So we left our oldest son home by himself, and we call him periodically. Everything was good, blah 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 blah, right? So, and we felt good about it because we were there for like 3-4 days. No police, nobody called us. It was all great. So we come back home and we walk into the garage and then into the kitchen, and we get by the refrigerator. And all of a sudden, my shoes were sticking to the floor.
Oh, no.
And it just, you know, it makes that one sound, that one noise.
And it's great.
And then I said, yeah. I say, Jared, what did you guys spill on the floor? He goes, oh, I weighed something out of the refrigerator. I go, okay, that can happen. He's a boy. Boys don't clean up very well. So then I immediately go out of the sliding glass door that leads to the deck. And I just walk out to the deck, just looking at the back 40. And then I turned and looked down. And in the flower pot, I saw some broken beer bottles.
Oh, no. Oh, no. What'd you do?
I go back then into the kitchen. My feet are sticking to the floor. I walk around the corner, out the garage, and I went to the garbage can. Opened up the garbage can, was full of beer cans and beer bottles. Walked back into the house. Jared! Did you have a party while we were gone?
And did he know it? Down. Did he come with his tail between his legs? Did he know he was busted?
Yeah, I did. But Dad, no police came. We were good.
All right. Well, that's good. Oh my gosh. What were the ramifications? Was it just a slap on the wrist, or were there ramifications that followed?
Well, no, then immediately I walk over to the next door neighbor and I asked her, was there a lot of loud? She goes, well, yeah, Jared did have some people over, and it was a little loud, but not bad.
So the neighbors heard it.
Yeah, didn't say anything to him. I said, well, can you just get the mop and clean this up, please? No harm, no foul.
Wow. That is very poor execution. That is very poor execution. Well, not really. No, very poor execution on Jared. Yeah. So
Hunter's done that.
Gary, they call me the hall monitor around here for a reason. Like my parents would go on an annual. They went on like a little casino trip with my extended family and their friends. Like they got a whole huge group together, rented a bus. They would go for an entire day to different places around the greater Midwest. They would leave at like 6 a.m, get home at like 10 o'clock at night, single day trip. It was one of my favorite days of the year because they would leave me home alone. I was an only child, so I didn't have any siblings I shared the house with. It was a Sunday in like February, so I think it was usually when the NBA All-Star game was on. The thing that I look forward to the most, not anything, suspicious. What I look forward to is just like making my own food and like being responsible for myself and just deciding when I wanted to do something all on my own. Like, I would tell people, like, oh, I had a great Sunday. Like, I had the whole place to myself. Like, oh, did you have people over? Did you have a party? Did you have girls over? No, I didn't do any of that. I stayed home by myself. I walked the dog a couple of times. I fed him. I made my own French bread pizzas. I just did my classic thing exactly how I wanted to. Turned sports on all day, and people thought I was so lame. It was such a thing that I would do. Hunter, you were shaking your head when Gary was trying to bring you into this. You did this.
I absolutely did this. My parents went camping, and I decided, hey, I'm going to have a party. Nobody's here. Everything was good. I got everything cleaned up. I even took the empty cans and bottles out to another dumpster so my parents couldn't find
it.
I thought I was brilliant.
That's what Jared should have done. Yes. You shouldn't do that, what you should do if you're going to do it.
Here's the problem, though. I have a hard time lying to my parents. So my dad calls just to check in the next morning and he's like, just to mess with me, goes, hey, Dave called from down the street, and he said there were a bunch of cars outside the house. What was going on? Right away, I'm like, oh, Dad, I'm so sorry. Like, I didn't, like, think it was going to get that big. It just turned into this big party. I'm sorry. Nothing broke. Everything's okay. No one got hurt. And he's like, oh, I was just messing with you.
Wow.
And I told on myself.
Busted.
Oh, I felt like such an idiot. I was doing chores for the next 4 weeks.
Did you do it again?
Nope. Never did it again. Learned my lesson.
Oh, wow. My goodness. How old were you, Hunter?
Yeah.
This would have been, I was like 17 going into my senior year of high school.
Statute of limitations is up on that. We're good.
So How old were you, Jesse?
I mean, when I was staying home alone, like, that was happening from the time I was like, I don't know, 12, 13. Like, they trusted me to pretty, but when you're an only child, they trust you to pretty, I don't know, it might even been younger than that they were letting me stay home and do that. 844-770-3776. We can do this. I trust the Wildy and Tausch fans. I'm not the one answering the phones, but I trust our fans. Do you have any legendary stories of either you or your children being left home alone, just like Gary and I have been trusted home alone here without Jason and Tausch around checking in on us, except for Jason is going to in a little bit. 844-770-3776. Give us a call or a text. If you'd like to remain anonymous, please do so. In sharing so, we can return that favor to you. 844-770-3776. We were going to do Power Rankings Tuesday. We might get to that coming up here before Jason Wildy joins us in a few minutes. We'll get to it at some point, but we'll take your stories on staying home alone. 844-770-3776. Gary busted his son having a party when he was younger. Hunter got busted with his dad lying to him, trying to catch him having a party. Great. Let's see if you can match those stories. 844-770-3776. Jesse and Gary, more Wildy and Tausch straight ahead.
This is Wildy and Tausch, presented by Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. Call Gina Della from Pella today, 855-PELLA-WI, and online at PellaWI.com/radio.
Mark Tauscher here to tell you a little bit more about Everlight Solar. We all know that electricity costs are on the rise. That's why you need to talk to my friends over at Everlight Solar. Their local team here in Madison is here to keep it simple. From your no-cost consultation to solar panel installation, the team at Everlight Solar will be with you every step of the way. Not only will they help you save money, but by switching to solar, you're also helping save the planet. Everlight Solar, a proud partner of Wisconsin Athletics. Check them out at EverlightSolar.com.
Hey, Drew Scott here.
And I'm Jonathan Scott, reminding you that life's better with a home policy from American Family Insurance. They can help you get just the right protection at just the right price and help you save when you bundle home and auto. Kind of like Goldilocks and the Three Bears. It'll be just right for you. We love a custom build. American Family Insurance. Insure carefully. Dream fearlessly. Get a quote and find an agent at AmFam.com.
Products not available in every state. Visit AmFam.com to learn how discounts may apply to you. American Family Mutual Insurance Company, S.I. and its operating company, 6000 American Parkway, Madison, Wisconsin.
Get 0% interest for up to 3 years at Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. I'm Gina Della from Pella. Pella's free in-home consultations make replacing or redesigning your windows and doors easy. We go beyond just measuring and handing you a quote by listening and educating you on all of your product options. And with DesignWorks, you can see what your home will look like before you buy. Order by March 31st to get 0% interest for up to 3 years. Set your free consultation at PellaWI.com.
Certain restrictions apply.
Hey everyone, Molly Brown from ESPN Madison here. For the best Southwestern food in the Madison area, it's always Pascual's Cantina for me and my family. Whether I'm enjoying my favorite taco salad, their awesome chips and guac, or one of their famous burritos, Pascual's is the best for authentic Southwestern fare. Visit one of their locations in Verona or Middleton today, or check out their menu and order online at pasquallscantina.com.
Bringing the flavors of the Southwest to the Midwest. Pascual's Cantina.
Your Honda gets you everywhere. When it needs service, you need Zimbrick Honda Service. Their customer service is second to none, and you can experience it yourself at two convenient Madison locations on Fish Hatchery Road and Grand Canyon Drive. Honda certified technicians handle it all. You can even get flexible payment options. Fix your car now and pay later. Apply online to see your options in seconds with no hard credit check. Make your service appointment online at ZimbrickHonda.com. Zimbrick Honda Service Center on Fish Hatchery Road and Grand Canyon Drive. Part of the Madison community since 1973. Shop Zimbrick Honda.
From color-changing alexandrite to shimmering zircon and everything in between at Chalmers Jewelers, you'll find high-quality, affordable, one-of-a-kind pieces. We source straight from the gem cutters, and we manufacture in-house from start to finish. As the manufacturer, we believe in truth in pricing. Never pay more for quality and stunning, beautiful jewelry. She's one-of-a-kind, and so should her jewelry be. While others may send your jewelry dreams to someone else to make, with us, your dreams become reality with the help of our custom jewelers, with you involved the whole way. With a staff that has over 200 years of combined experience, why buy from a place that marks up jewelry made by the thousands? When you can buy direct from Chalmers for that one-of-a-kind piece that is better quality, often for less.
Chalmers Jewelers in Middleton
and Madison.
Step into nostalgia with the Miller High Life Dive Bar of the Week. Listen to Rutledge and Hamilton every Thursday, and we will let you know where you can enjoy $2 Miller High Lifes. To celebrate our love for dive bars, me and Matt are going to tell you about some of our favorites, featuring one extra special dive bar that will have $2 High Lifes on special for the week. Taste the champagne of beer in its natural environment. A delightfully different dive bar in Wisconsin, like the Nitty Gritty in Middleton, the Village Green, Riley Tavern, and Remington's Tavern.
From the preps.
Russell spins his way into the paint with contact, finishes, and a foul.
That was pretty.
To the pros.
Beverly launches from three, and he knocks it down.
The biggest games play on 100.5 ESPN.
.44-770-3776, the ESPN Wisconsin talk and text line. Jesse Nelson, Gary Ellerson, your cousin subs of the day, in for Wilde and Tausch. All I did was make a passing comment that Jason and Tausch left us home alone, and Jason was coming up to check in on us at 10:30. And that led Gary to tell an amazing story about his son throwing a party when they left him home alone back in the day. And then Hunter followed that up with what may have even been a better story about him throwing a party and getting busted. And now we're taking your stories. 844-770-3776. Hunter tells me that we have a special mystery guest who is on hold to join the show. So we're going to get to him or her, I guess. I don't know who it is first. And then a couple of callers before we get to Jason Wilde coming up. Keep your stories coming on the text line, 844-770-3776. Mystery guest, please reveal yourself.
Hi, this is Chris Barrow calling in from Baltimore.
Oh, my God. This is my Gary, this is my brother-in-law, Chris.
No way.
Chris, oh
he's
my God.
Listening.
So
he's
did you listening. Throw, this could get scary for a number of reasons. I don't know if you're ratting out Becca, if you're ratting out yourself. I don't think I've done anything wrong. What do you got for us?
I'll tell you what, Jesse, the reason that you and Becca work out so well together is that you are polar opposites in this aspect. Growing up back in the day, we were about two houses down from the chief of police, and parents were out and about quite a bit. And even with all that going on, we would still have parties at the house. And when it came to the cleaning perspective, we were always on top of it because we were always so excited to have, you know, adults in the room. We were about 2 years apart between Beck and I, and then 4 years between our younger brother and 4 years between the younger brother and our youngest sister. So whenever we had, you know, quote-unquote adults we were always excited. And then when it came to the aftermath, we were always extra careful to make sure that, you know, not only did Wayne and Carlo not find out, but also Larry Seifel up the road. So,
who was the ringleader of the party? Was Becca the ringleader who was like, okay, parents are gone, we're throwing a rager? Or was this like you instigating it?
It was never necessarily ragers, but it was always just a few people at the house, you know, making sure that, you know, nothing too crazy as far as volume or outside activity with the cars, and then making sure we didn't tear up the house in the process. So,
you rascals. That's amazing.
Yeah, oh my goodness.
So my wife was the troublemaker. I'm the goody two shoes hall monitor, and she's the troublemaker who has organized all the parties in the neighborhood.
Absolutely. That's why you guys always worked out so well.
That's
incredible. Chris, thanks for calling in, man. Hope all is well.
So here's a whole different deal.
Great, thank you. That's a great show. I appreciate it.
Yeah, no problem. So Chris, up the ante a little bit, sounds like Chris had lookouts.
Oh, yeah, that sounds monitor. Like they had an entire operation all in place there, yeah.
Yes, that's a little bit different.
That's what apparently your son needed, or Hunter, when he was throwing his party. We got a couple of texts coming out. I want to make sure we do get to Jason. It is his show, after all, so we should make plenty of room for him. So let's quickly get to Andy in Green Bay has a story for us. Tough to top my brother-in-law and the stories we've heard already. But Andy in Green Bay, you're up next on Wildy and Tausch. What's your best Home Alone story?
I almost burnt my parents' house down.
All right, let's hear about it.
I used to work at a tavern, and I was probably in my 20s. Now I'm in my 40s. But thought I'd have some friends over after work. They were gone. They were up in Door County, and decided to cook some chicken wings in the fryer. Forgot that the fryer was still on.
Oh, no.
Oh, my gosh. Fire department came because I didn't know what the heck was going on when I woke up. But, yeah, that was an interesting one.
Oh, so you were asleep?
Yep, I fell asleep.
Oh, no.
Can I ask, were there drinking involved?
There was drinking involved before we left work, but... no, just fell asleep. I forgot about the wings. My parents had to repaint the kitchen, and they had left me home to watch the house. Yep, because the smell got so bad, they had to redo it.
That's
painting and everything.
Oh, that's brutal.
That's a grease fire. Those are worse.
And this, you were in your 20s. You weren't even like, you know, a teenager or whatever. And you were like, okay, this is like your first time making popcorn. You hit the popcorn button. Everybody makes that mistake once. You were like a fully functioning adult by this time.
Correct.
That actually makes it worse, Andy. I got to admit. It'd be a better, like, you'd be more forgiven if you were like 16 and this happened. The fact that you're in your 20s and that happened, oh boy, that's a tough look.
Oh, I woke up and my eyeballs were as big as, I was like, what is going on? Yeah, I had to call fire department.
Oh my gosh, that is terrible. Andy, thanks so much for sharing it, though. We appreciate hearing about your misery. 844-770-3776. Again, if you have more stories that you want to share with us of being left home alone, just like Gary and I have been left home alone to take care of the Wildy and Tausch house while Jason and Tausch are on assignment on spring break for the rest of the week, please keep them coming. 844-770-3776. If you're going to call in and share your story, wait a little bit, though, because I don't want to put you on hold for 20 minutes while we talk with our friend. Right. The usual host of this show. He's always welcome because his name is on the marquee and it's first. Jason Wildy, scheduled to appear. Talking Packers. I wonder if he's got any good Home Alone stories. We'll find out next. It's Wildy and Tausch.
On the air, on demand, on social, on Wisconsin sports. Serving Wisconsin sports fans. This is 100.5 ESPN. This is Wildy and Tausch, driven by Zimbrick Chevrolet in Sun Prairie on 100.5 ESPN. See their full inventory at ZimbrickChevrolet.com.
Prize Picks is America's number one fantasy sports app with over 3 million active members. They are the easiest and most exciting way to play daily fantasy sports. All you do, pick more or less on a 2-6 player stat projection and watch the winnings roll in. Whether it's tournament season or the fight for playoff home court, there's no shortage of high-stakes basketball moments this time of year. Prize Picks even offers injury insurance so that your entries stay in play even if one of your players gets hurt. for basketball games. If you have a player who exits the game in the first half and does not return in the second, Prize Picks will have your back and not count that as a loss. Prize Picks is really simple to play. I can make my picks and submit my entry in less than 60 seconds. Prize Picks also offers weekly promotions and special offers for the biggest moments in sports. Download the app today and use code WI for a first deposit match up to $100. That's code WI on Prize Picks for a deposit match up to $100. Pick more, pick less. It's that easy.
LabCorp Clinical Trials is changing to a new name, Fortrea. While the name may be different, Fortrea combines decades of great experience and professionalism with new opportunities for clinical trial participation. It's more than a mission and more than a new name. Fortrea is dedicated to moving healthcare forward. To learn more about the future of healthcare and upcoming clinical trials, visit us at FortreaClinicalTrials.com. That's FortreaClinicalTrials.com.
Since J&K Security Solutions opened in 1987, our attention to detail and customer service have been our strongest assets. I'm President Jeffrey Beckman. We'll always do our best to find the most efficient and cost-effective solution to every job we tackle. Whether it's security for your home or business, installing video surveillance, or being able to control your garage doors from your phone, we can help you feel empowered with simple and user-friendly technology. Let's work together to secure your home or business. JKSecurity.com.
Get your team together. Softball is back for 2024. Jesse Nelson here. Registration for Madison School and Community Recreation's Adult Summer Softball Leagues is now open. Men's, women's, and all-gender slow pitch and women's fast pitch leagues are forming now for the summer season. MSCR Softball Leagues offer fun for every level of player and welcome all participants. Spend your summer evenings with us on the diamond. For more information and to register, go to MSCRSportsLeagues.org. That's MSCRSportsLeagues.org.
What is a better buying experience? Well, you're minutes away from a better buying experience at Simden Chevy in Mount Horeb. Jim Rutledge here. To me, a better buying experience is a personal experience. That's what Dan and his sales team have set up at Simden Chevy in Mount Horeb. You're going to have the experience that you're looking for. You're going to define what that better buying experience is for you, and they're going to get you in the vehicle that you need and that you want, whether it's new or new to you. So when you're looking for a better buying experience, go to Simden Chevy in Mount Horeb.
ESPN Madison is on Wisconsin sports. Catch up on anything you missed on the Varsity Podcast on Wisconsin On Demand. Brought to you by Zimbrick Honda, a proud supporter of Wisconsin Badger Athletics. If you're looking to purchase, finance, or service a new or pre-owned Honda, stop local. Part of the Madison community since 1973.
Mark Tauscher here, and when I was on the hunt for a hot tub, I found Patio Pleasures, a locally owned family business. Patio Pleasures has a passion for making your home a place for recovery and relaxation. And that's why I'm excited about my new cold plunge from Patio Pleasures. They only showcase premium recovery and relaxation products, and that's how I know it's going to be great. Gear up for spring and check out Patio Pleasures' two incredible showrooms, Madison West and Sun Prairie.
Like, share, and follow ESPN Madison everywhere. Follow us on Twitter, Instagram, Facebook, and TikTok for more great content from ESPN Madison. This is 100.5 ESPN and Wisconsin On Demand.
The show is Wildy and Tausch. Neither Wildy nor Tausch are here to host it today. So you get Cousin Subs of the Day, Jesse Nelson, usually the producer of the show, and Gary Ellerson, who hosted the show yesterday. Hunter Vaughn is our producer, and joining us now is the regular host of the show. It's Jason Wildy from Green Bay. Jason, good morning. You just didn't trust Gary and I to stay home alone today?
That's not it at all. I knew you guys would be fine. You asked if I would be willing. I said I'd be happy to do it, and here I am. It is not a lack of trust in either. Well, maybe it's a slight lack of trust in you, Jesse.
Yeah,
Gary or Hunter.
It has led us to story time with Gary and with some fans here at the 10 o'clock hour. So, Jason, I don't know if you're more like me and you've always been a hall monitor, including in your youth, or if you're more like Gary's son and Hunter, who have been quite rebellious in throwing parties when their parents have trusted them to stay home alone. But since we've framed this as you and Tausch have trusted Gary and I to stay home alone and take care of the house while you're gone, We've started hearing some stories of parties that folks have held while, including from my brother-in-law, who just called in last night, which is incredible. Apparently, my wife is quite the rebel when it comes to hosting parties at her parents' house growing up. So that was something to learn.
Wow.
Yeah. It was a big revelation day here on Wildy and Tausch. Jason, did you ever get busted or have any stories of any friends that have been busted throwing parties when the parents have been gone?
Yeah, I would never try to take your hall monitor status, Jesse, but I was a pretty straight arrow. We did not have any instances where my parents were out of town and I threw a party at our house. I always wished I did, though. Like when I was young, and Gary and I are in, I think, in a quasi similar age bracket, even though I give him a hard time about playing for the Badgers when I was 4 years old. I remember the movie Weird Science, where they throw a party while the parents are gone. They also create a woman out of like a doll, which was interesting. But it was, I remember seeing that movie. It came out like 84-ish, and thinking, how cool would it be to throw a party when your parents were gone? But I never had the gumption to do it. And I don't think my parents left me like unattended very often during my youth, like even in high school. Like I don't think they did, not out of lack of trust, just out of, you know, we weren't rolling in the dough, so they didn't go on a lot of trips without their kids or anything like that. So I just don't think I had the opportunities. I think I would have had I had the opportunity.
How about that? So Jason, what is it? Is it, because I don't know your family members, so brothers and sisters, how many do you have?
I have a younger brother who is 5.5 years younger than me.
Oh, so you were in complete control then of with the older brother. Yeah, so I was happy. Had to be you.
So yeah, if you're, I mean, I can give you his number. You can find out if he threw any parties. I would have been a freshman at UW-Madison when he was a freshman in high school. So his high school run, I was in college. So I'm guessing, and you know how it is. You know, I think most second or third kids or fourth kids or wherever you are in the pecking order, Jesse has no idea because he's an only child. But the rules get a little more lax and you're able to get away with more and more things the farther down the pecking order you get. Also, you get, you know, my biggest bitter still holding a grudge from my youth is that Air Jordans came out when I was in grade school. And I had to settle for the generic version of the Air Jordans. And my brother got the new pair every year when Jordan came out with a new one. So not that I'm bothered by that at all. And not that that's affected the fact that I've got about 75 pairs of shoes now to try and make up for it. But he may have thrown parties when I wasn't there when I was at Madison. But, yeah, for me, I was Mr. Responsible. I also, and it's funny you bring this up because I have a friend who was a basketball coach, and in his final year, he's now a principal, but in his final year as the boys basketball coach at this high school, all of his best players threw a party at one of the players' houses while the parents were away, and the police were called, and they all got busted. And so, like, the top seven players in his rotation all got suspended and kicked off the basketball team. And so, you know, for you as an elite athlete and me as a mediocre athlete who just wanted to stay on the team, I couldn't afford to risk that kind of stuff.
No, that's never good. You don't want that. That's not good.
Jason Wildy joining Wildy and Tausch here. Jesse Nelson, Gary Ellerson, your cousin, subs of the day, in for Jason and Tausch, although Jason's right here with us. Jason, we were talking with Evan Cohen of Unsportsmanlike on ESPN Radio in the first hour of the show. When would you say the Green Bay Packers have been truly all in pursuit of a championship? Because Evan's assertion is that the Packers never fully go all in, and that's why they've been so successful for multiple decades now.
Yeah, well, you can look at that two ways, but I totally agree with him that they've never truly gone all in. Their idea of all in was in the, you know, kind of the 20, 21, 22 years when they kept pushing money to keep their own guys out into future caps. Those years, they didn't, as we've talked about, as free agency was approaching, before they signed McKinney, before they signed Jacobs, they weren't active players in the free agent market in Rodgers' final three seasons in Green Bay. And to me, all in would have been really pushing money out into the future for your own guys and going and getting players to augment your roster and making moves at the trade deadline. Remember, there were multiple times at the trade deadline where there were reports that Goody tried to acquire guys, but never actually did. And so I think Evan's right about that. And then it depends on what side of the coin you want to fall on with this, right? It is why they have been successful without having many hiccups in the last 30 years, along with having great quarterbacking. But it's also why, you know, for fans that would have liked to have seen them win more than two Super Bowls with back-to-back Hall of Fame quarterbacks, it's probably also why they didn't manage to win more Super Bowls, right? Because maybe they were that one player away. Like, maybe they were. And again, Jordan Love is fantastic. It looks like he's going to be their starting quarterback for the next decade plus. But are they in any way different in 2020 or 2021 if, in addition to Devontae Adams, they have an emerging T. Higgins on their roster? I don't know. I don't live in that fantasy land, but there were certainly opportunities for them to get guys that would have augmented their roster and maybe improved their chances. And the guy that I think of, and I know they didn't win the Super Bowl or get there in those 3 years that he was added, but when they went out and got Julius Peppers, and I'll never forget waking up that morning, and, you know, Rap Sheet and Adam Schefter and all those guys are so good at their jobs. They spend, I would love their money. I would not want their lives, because yeah, I don't want to be tethered to my phone and waiting for all these text messages. Mm-hmm. But that signing was such a surprise because none of those insiders had any inkling. And we found out that Julius Peppers was a Packer when he posted a picture of himself inside Lambeau Field on social mm-hmm. media. And they went to two NFC championship games in the 3 year span that he was there. And the 1 year that they didn't was the year that they didn't have Jordy Nelson when he tore his ACL in the preseason in 2015. So that's a great example of the kind of player that tilts the field. He had touchdown fumble returns and interception returns for touchdowns. Like, that three-year span, he was fantastic. And to Evan's point, yeah, it's great that they were able to have sustained success and be in the playoffs virtually every year, but maybe more of those type pickups would have been the difference between being in the playoffs every year and having another title in their trophy case in addition to the two they have with Favre and Rodgers.
Jason, listen, I think you're always going to have maybe this rift, and however people perceive it to be, between Aaron Rodgers and Brian Gutekunst. Now, I heard whispers, and I just want to get your thoughts on this, in that while they go out and do two day one signings in Xavier McKinney and in Josh Jacobs, but they never got any help for Aaron Rodgers when he needed it, and they did it for Jordan Love because that's his guy. What's your thoughts on that?
Yeah, I mean, look, I think, did Rodgers have some reasonable complaints or things that he didn't like? I think he did. Do I think he handled it very well? I don't. And I think he bears some responsibility for that. I do think that, you know, they're not – I'm confident in the fact that, much like with Aaron Rodgers, Brian Gutekunst isn't going to Jordan Love and going, hey, what do you think of us swapping out Aaron Jones for Josh Jacobs, right? That wasn't a conversation that apparently even Matt LaFleur was involved in,
right,
much less the quarterback. But, you know, when they did dive into free agency in 2019, they got two edge rushers, a safety, and an offensive lineman. And while you could argue, well, those aren't weapons for Rodgers, you know, the Smith brothers definitely made their defense better, right? I mean,
yeah.
Clay Matthews had faded. They had released Nick Perry. So that helped the defense. They went to an NFC championship game in 19, even with Rodgers and that offense not humming the way it would in 20 and 21. So do I think that Aaron Rodgers has a legitimate beef that they didn't do enough to support him beyond drafting wide receivers during his tenure? Sure. I think he's got a legitimate complaint about that. But I think Brian Gutekunst could turn around and say, hey, man, you know, I tried to get the defense fixed for you because that was never good enough during your tenure. And quite frankly, we had a lot of weapons on offense. And sometimes you didn't play as well when all the chips were on the table either. So those two I don't see having a whole lot of conversations. I'm guessing that Goody is not on Aaron Rodgers' Christmas card list if he sends those out. or vice versa.
No.
Oh, back to yesterday. No. But I think those two, and Gary, you know, you and I have talked about this in the press box and other and pregame shows and stuff. Like, I do think that that dysfunction, it would have been nice to see what they could have accomplished together if Goody and Rodgers had found a way to be more connected in terms of Goody making Rodgers feel like more of a part of it, Rodgers not being quite as, you know, maybe difficult or demanding as he could be. And we'll never know because that era is over and we don't have a time machine. But I look at the time I've covered this team and there have been some heartbreaking losses for them. There's been some dysfunction, certainly. There's certainly been a lot of winning, but there haven't been a lot of all-in instances, and there are plenty of what-ifs because I do think that, you know, fans that feel like, yeah, it's great that we got two Super Bowls, but that was it. I think while I don't want them to be greedy or, you know, envious of other, you know, like the Patriots, I understand why they're disappointed because there were opportunities missed for a variety of reasons, whether it was what they did on the field in crucial games or what they didn't do to augment the roster.
Jason Wilde joining his own show on Wilde and Tyler. That's the kind of Packers insight that we love
like
to hear
that.
From Jason Wilde.
I like that.
Hey,
I like
fun
that.
To be asked
joining
questions
own show.
On my
I love
show.
That.
That kind of works out well.
Man. I like that. That's
you really
good.
Do bring your best material when you're a guest. It's uncanny.
That's good.
Tosh is on to something with it. So, Jason, a lot of this conversation was inspired by Mike McCarthy talking with Adam Schefter at the NFL owners meetings in Orlando, and he said that he's used to being part of a team because the Cowboys have been inactive in free agency relatively this offseason. And McCarthy said that you know, he's used to being part of teams that don't really do a lot in free agency, so it's nothing new for him. They're going to develop their own flavor or players. It was really quite a line from Big Mike. Do you think at all Mike McCarthy is jealous of Matt LaFleur being with Brian Gutekunst and Goody being more active in free agency than Ted Thompson ever was?
Yeah, I don't think so because, again, and this is what kind of bothers me of the narrative of Goody. And again, those of you who listen to this show regularly who think I hate him, I don't want to go down the Christmas card route again. But here's the reality. He hasn't been that active in free agency. Okay, so he was active this year with Josh Jacobs replacing he swapped out a stud running back for a younger stud running back. It's not like there's no net gain there other than the years of Josh Jacobs being 26 and Aaron Jones being 29. And they added a safety who they paid a pretty penny for and who better be a field-tilting player for them given the expectations. But between that 19 free agent group that we talked about with the Smith brothers, Billy Turner and Adrian Amos, and these two guys, they haven't done jack in free agency. So it's not like Goody was some sort of, you know, it's not like he was, you know, John Schneider going crazy out there in Seattle while he was with Pete Carroll, who, by the way, John Schneider hasn't done jack in free agency either this year. You know, you guys know how I feel about McCarthy. One of my favorite moments with McCarthy, I'm not in the mood for drama tonight, Jason. It was when the day before the trade deadline, and I'll never forget this. Bill Huber from Sports Illustrated asks Mike about what his expectations are for the trade deadline. And he says, is that tomorrow? I thought it was next week. And we all kind of look at each other. Like, wait a minute, does the head coach of the Packers not know when the trade deadline is? And then he said, and he laughed and said, that's what it's like around here. is that you don't. It doesn't matter when the trade deadline is because you know the Packers aren't going to do anything. And it was one of the funniest moments he's had. And it sounds like he kind of used a version of that with Schefter. But, yeah, he knew what to expect, and that was probably not a lot of activity. That's why when I bring up, you know, Charles Woodson, who was a bargain signing at the time, when I bring up Julius Peppers, those stand out so much during Ted Thompson's tenure because they were such rarities. You know, I saw this, you know, and look, I don't know what the expectations are for Chase Young. I know he had a neck surgery and there's a concern there, right, about his availability. And the Saints kind of signed him on spec with the risk of him not being able to play. But those are the kinds of signings that, you know, they can't, if you hit on them, they can be game changers for your team. And if we're going to honestly review the Thompson and Gutekunst GM eras, I think we can safely say that there were instances where you got great players at bargain prices and they really hit, but they were few and far between because the attempts were few and far between.
So are you working on Christmas cards or what are you doing here with your couple of days off? Like you took the day off from the show and now you're on the show.
Yeah. So I Paula had me bringing in some Easter decorations, taking out the St. Patrick's Day decorations. I didn't get that done last week. So I was doing that. Let's see. I walked the dogs. I am taking the girls. The girls don't have school at spring break. I'm taking the girls to Dave and Buster's to play some Papa Shot.
All right.
Oh, yeah.
For lunch. So we're looking forward to that. But, yeah, this is not like, you know, I'm not traveling to France. I'm trying to get my life in order. And I did. I took 2 days off, which I was on Jen Gabe and Chewy. I'll be on KBN. I was on this show. So I don't even think I have to put in as today being a day off technically. But I appreciate you guys letting me get some stuff done. You've both made the Christmas card list for 2024.
Ah, yeah, us right next to Goody, Gary. How about that? We're on
there
the list.
Go. I love it. I love it. I got to get in my address.
Jason, enjoy Dave and enjoy Dave and Buster's. Enjoy the couple of days off. Thanks so much for taking the time here today and joining us. We promise we'll be good the rest of the next couple of days.
I know you will be, and I appreciate you guys giving me a little bit of time to get some stuff done. So thanks for stepping into the breach, boys. Take care. Be good.
Jason Wilde.
Thank you.
Joining his own show. Nothing like it. He's really it's just unbelievable when Tausch says he's so much better.
Oh, he's great.
We have an entire segment called Where's Wilde, where Jason joins other shows on ESPN Wisconsin. We try to guess where he was, and then Tausch says how much insight he brings to those other shows versus not having an opinion when he's hosting this show. It's unbelievable.
Oh,
so I wouldn't say he never has an opinion. Tausch usually goes a little further than that than I do, but it's still great having Jason able to be part of the show today, even when he took a couple of days off. Wilde and Tausch, Jesse Delson, Gary Ellerson, your cousin's sub of the day. We will get to some of your staying home alone stories coming in on the Wilde and Tausch Twitter feed and the ESPN.
Hey, do we have it up on Twitter, Jess?
We will get the question posted on Twitter. Twitter, because it
is that a poll?
Because it lives – well, we have a poll question about baseball, which I'm excited to review some of the returns on to start the 11 o'clock
hour.
I want to ask people on our social media platforms their stories about staying home alone, but because it lives on the internet forever, you never know if people are going to be shy about that kind of thing. What the heck? We'll let it fly.
Okay.
We'll put it up on Twitter and Facebook here to get our responses there, too.
Yeah,
we got
put
some
that
texts.
Up on Twitter, Jesse.
We'll do that. We'll also have some text that
Jesse,
we're happy to review.
Poll. Make a poll, Jesse. You can make
I
a poll.
Thought Tausch had days off here. What the heck's going on? We'll get to it. We'll do it next. It's Wilde and Tausch.
From the preps.
Russell spins his way into the paint with contact, finishes, and a foul.
That was pretty.
To the pros.
Beverly launches from three, and he knocks it down.
The biggest games play on 100.5 ESPN. Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin present your Badger Minute. Here's Alex Strofe.
This Badger Minute brought to you by Stoughton Trailers. Big trailers and big opportunity at Stoughton Trailers. Learn more about why a career at Stoughton Trailers might be for you. Go to stojobs.com.
Longtime Wisconsin State Journal columnist Jim Polzine joined Kyle Bruston-Nortman on ESPN Wisconsin earlier this week and compared the current state of men's basketball coach Greg Gard to former football coach Paul Christ's hot seat and what it would take to move on from Gard.
I didn't think Chris McIntosh would fire Paul Christ, but again, something in that two-hour conversation changed Chris McIntosh's mind, and I think it would take a similar conversation with Greg Gard probably to get him to the point where he's ready to move on and find someone new.
Find the full conversation with Jim Polzine on Wisconsin on Demand or wherever you get your podcasts.
Get no interest for up to 3 years at Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. Don't wait. You have to order by March 31st. Visit PellaWI.com.
Hey, Jesse Nelson here, and summer is coming, so it's time to start thinking maybe about a summer job. I was an umpire when I was growing up, and it provided me so many great skills that I actually still use in my everyday work today. And Madison School and Community Recreation is now hiring for a bunch of positions this summer, including day camp and youth program leaders, outdoor adventure staff, support staff for individuals with disabilities, sports instructors, my personal favorite, officials, and more. A lot of my friends have said the same thing, too. A couple of them were camp instructors, and they said all the things that they did were so valuable that they are able to translate into the workplace right now in their everyday careers. Full and part-time positions with daytime and evening hours are available, and no matter your interest, no matter your schedule, no matter where you live, there's a position for everyone. At MSCR, you can make an immediate impact in the community and gain meaningful experience. Start your summer adventure today. Apply at MSCR.org. That's MSCR.org.
Your dream home with American Family Insurance. And you can weather any storm. You'll also save up to 25% by bundling home, auto, and life. American Family Insurance. Get a quote. Find an agent at amfam.com.
Products not available in every state. Discounts may not apply to all coverages on an auto or home policy. Discounts do not apply to life insurance policies. Visit amfam.com to learn how discounts may apply to you. American Family Mutual Insurance Company, S.I. and its operating companies, American Family Life Insurance Company, 6000 American Parkway, Madison, Wisconsin.
The GRB Rays have established themselves as one of the top baseball programs in the Midwest and the country. GRB Academy offers training programs for players of all ages and skill levels. Learn from some of the best baseball coaches in the area and find the program that fits your training goals and your schedule. Spots are filling up fast, so visit grbacademy.com to sign up now. That's grbacademy.com. GRB Academy, baseball for the serious player.
At Starion Bank, they pride themselves on being a super community bank. Small enough to show they care about you and the communities they serve, while being large enough to make big things happen. With three Madison area branches in Middleton, Sun Prairie, and Monona, Starion Bank is here investing in your community while offering valuable personal and business banking services. Start your experience with Starion Bank today by going to starionbank.com. Member FDIC.
Hi, this is Lee, inviting you to Ruth's Chris Steakhouse in Middleton. We got a great happy hour every day of the week from 4 o'clock to 7, and our patio during the summer is open too. If you're getting married, special occasion, a birthday, anniversary, or even a business meeting, we've got all the accommodations right here at Ruth's Chris Steakhouse. You work hard, and sometimes you're not sure what you want to do, where you want to spend your money. I want to encourage you to come into Ruth's Chris Steakhouse and say hello. It'd be a pleasure to meet you.
On the air, on demand, on social, on Wisconsin Sports. Serving Wisconsin sports fans. This is 100.5 ESPN.
While the parents are away, Jesse and Gary are taking your stories about your parties gone wrong. It's Wildy and Tausch, Jesse and Gary today. Jesse Nelson, Gary Ellerson, your cousin sub of the day, in for Jason and Tausch. Special thanks again to Jason Wildy joining us last segment. If you missed that, if you missed Evan Cohen earlier, if you missed any of today's show, remember you can subscribe
on Apple, Spotify, wherever you get your podcasts, to Wildy and Tausch and all of your favorite ESPN Wisconsin shows. In fact, just download the Wisconsin On Demand app so you have them all in one place on your phone. 844-770-3776. That is where we are taking your stories of being left home alone. Let's get to this one from a 414 who wishes to remain anonymous. Hunter's got it up on the video stream here on YouTube at ESPN Madison and ESPN Milwaukee, where you should also subscribe to us. My parents were gone. My older sister had some friends over for throwing a party. I got caught stealing a Rush street sign. The police took me home, so they had to talk to someone in charge. I went into the house, told my sister there was police at the door. They all thought I was kidding until they saw the look on my face. Everything went well, except I'm surprised I'm still alive. Took a lot of bleep for a long time. That's a good one from whoever that is in the 414. So, sister's in charge, sister's throwing a party, parents are gone. He's out doing something totally different, reckless, gets busted by the police trying to steal a street sign. He gets taken home and has to go talk to someone in charge, and it's his sister throwing a party that she probably wasn't supposed to. Brings the police home, and they're not even there to bust the party.
Oh, my God. You gotta, so when you're doing stuff like that, you gotta be on the same page with everybody, don't you?
Come on. You would think there'd be a little bit of coordination on their end. You would think. I didn't have siblings. I don't know. I feel like there's always some conversation that takes place there. For sure. Dave and Aaron texted in a story. Had a party at my grandparents' house when they were out of town. Their neighbor called the house, and I said, oh, yeah, they said I could have some people over. Got rid of all the evidence before they got home. Thought I was in the clear. Same neighbor called, following up with the grandparents later when they got back, and he got busted retroactively. So wasn't busted in real time.
The neighbors called.
Thought he was in the clear. Yeah, neighbors called, had everything planned. Just going to tell them grandparents said it was okay to be over here. And then, of course, there's the follow-up. You forget about the follow-up, that there could be long-term rant. That's everyone's problem. That was your son's problem with his party. That was Hunter's problem. Nobody thinks about what's going to happen the step after you're in the clear. Everyone thinks, okay, if I just get to Sunday, I'm good. Nobody thinks about, like, Tuesday, Ethel next door might call grandpa and ask if there was a party over the weekend. Yeah, no one thinks of all that stuff. If you're going to scheme this out, everybody, you got to scheme it the right way.
You got to scheme it the right way.
Unreal. This has been so much fun taking these stories. We will continue to review them as we get into the 11 o'clock hour. And if you want to call in and share your story, the phone lines are open at 844-770-3776. Of course, you can keep texting them in as well. We will take them there as well. 844-770-3776. All this inspired by me simply saying that Jason and Tausch trusted us home alone today, except Jason was checking in when he joined us at 10:30. All of a sudden, we get these amazing stories of our fans and of us staying home alone. It's just unreal. 10 o'clock hour. We will get to those aforementioned power rankings, unless there's some great stories that come in. But I do want to get to those power rankings because I love them so much. I think it provides great national perspective of what people think of the Green Bay Packers, and it'll give us a little bit of more Packers conversation to have. So we'll do that in 2 minutes. Don't go anywhere. Jesse Nelson, Gary Ellerson in for Wildy and Tausch.
Don't go anywhere. Another hour of Wildy and Tausch, presented by Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin, is coming up next on ESPN Wisconsin, the ESPN app, and Wisconsin On Demand.
Mark Tauscher here for Chalmers Jewelers. I've been a big fan of Scott and Garrett and the whole team at Chalmers Jewelers for years now. I go there, my friends go there, and most importantly, my wife loves it whenever I get her something from Chalmers Jewelers. What's right around the corner? Mother's Day. Show some love to the incredible women in your life and stop at Chalmers Jewelers, the place to go for that perfect gift. I recommend Chalmers Jewelers in Middleton and Madison.
Chalmers Jewelers in Middleton
and Madison.
Hey, this is Craig Karmazin. Join Kyle Wallace and me every Sunday morning for Sunday Karma on a Good Karma Brands radio station, 100.5 ESPN, WTLX, Monona, Madison.
Broadcasting live from the Everlight Solar Studio, this is your Metro Kia of Madison Sports Center.
What is up, Madison? I'm Hunter Vaughn. Your Sports Center update is brought to you by ESPN Madison on YouTube. Subscribe to watch all your favorite daily shows, including Mr. Irrelevant with Alex Strofe, exclusively streaming every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday, and special featured content. Subscribe today to watch ESPN Madison on YouTube. Well, today was supposed to be the season opener for the Milwaukee Brewers and the New York Mets, but due to some rain in New York, the game has been postponed to tomorrow, and that will be a 12:40 first pitch for the Brewers and the Mets. After that three-game series in New York, Milwaukee will head back home for their home opener on Tuesday against the Minnesota Twins. That'll be a 3:10 first pitch from AmFam Field. In college hoops, the Wisconsin women's basketball team is hosting Illinois State in the Super 16 of the WNIT tournament tonight. Tip-off from the Kohl Center is set for 6 o'clock. The winner plays either IPFW or St. Louis in the Great Eight. And the Marquette Golden Eagles, of course, taking on NC State in the Sweet 16 Friday.
Metro Kia of Madison, Madison's trusted Kia dealer. Stop into Metro Kia on the east side of Madison or MetroKiaOfMadison.com.
The 11 o'clock hour of Wildy and Tausch, with no Wildy and no Tausch. Jesse Nelson, normally the producer of this show. I'm the cousin sub of the day hosting. Gary Ellerson, he was the cousin sub yesterday. He'll be the cousin sub tomorrow. And he's the cousin sub today. Joining me hosting the show. And Hunter Vaughn is our producer behind the glass, resident Dallas Cowboys fan, having a heck of an offseason producing the show and getting ready for his Cowboys to make an NFC run.
And just don't forget, I got a little show with Homer for an hour.
Oh, yeah. Don't forget to tell everybody about the little show, as you penned it yesterday.
I got a little show with Homer for an hour at 5 o'clock today.
That's 5 o'clock. Gary Ellerson joining Homer for the Homer Hour today. Tony Smith's with you, too. That's what you were saying. Tony's on for like a few minutes, and then you got the rest of it?
Yeah.
That's awesome. Well, of course, as Homer and Tony are getting ready for Marquette in the Sweet 16 tomorrow in Dallas. Going to be a fun one. Can't wait to watch that. Gary, did we talk Marquette? Are you as a Wisconsin alumni, are you rooting for Marquette in the Sweet 16? Are you disinterested? Where do you stand on Marquette as they get set to play as a Badgers alum?
Good question. I do root for Marquette when the Badgers are out. I mean, it's still about the state of Wisconsin, even though I went to, and I don't know how Ben Bruss feel about this, because he may feel a little different because he actually played for the Badgers and had to play against Marquette. But for me, just from a fan standpoint, although I played football there, I don't think it's the same. I root for Marquette because I think it's good for the state of Wisconsin.
I don't know if it's just because I grew up in Southeast Wisconsin or what the deal is, but I root for Marquette 364 days of the year. The one I don't, my allegiance is to the University of Wisconsin. I didn't go here. I went to Bradley. I just chose Wisconsin over Marquette.
You went to Bradley?
I did go to Bradley University, Peoria, Illinois. Yep.
In Peoria. Yes. You know, it scares me going across that bridge to get into Peoria.
Well, yeah. I mean, especially, we saw something on the news last night about people
that have fears going
over bridges now, especially with the tragedy in Baltimore. But, Peoria is known for its – there's Oh, really? Really?
She was recruited by the Bradley Braves. So I've been to basketball tournaments there when I was in high school, and then my daughter ended up playing basketball for Evansville, which was in the same conference.
Yeah, Missouri Valley. All right. Proud Missouri Valley Conference.
Spent plenty of time in Peoria.
I love it. There a couple weeks
Hersey
ago.
Hawkins.
Yep, Hersey Hawkins is there. Brian Wardle, former Marquette player. Last time they were in the Final Four, he's been the head coach there for almost a decade now. Yeah. Doing a great job. Love the squad down there. 844-770-3776. But I'm cheering for Marquette to do well this weekend, too. I would love to see them in the Final Four make a run at a national championship. They are among the best teams in the country, and I love seeing when the best teams are able to compete in the Final Four. You get that one Cinderella and then three teams that are definitely the big championship contenders. I would love for Marquette
Marquette to be one of the teams in that fight next week, continuing on. Speaking of continuing on, we do have more stories coming in on the text line, Gary. I got it up on Twitter for you also at Wildy and Tausch. So we'll take your stories on Twitter at Wildy and Tausch, but also at 844-770-3776. Because we are being left home alone by Jason and Tausch, we are taking your stories of parties that have gone wrong by being left home alone. So here's one from Ian in East Troy. Last day of senior year, the old lady downstairs busted up my party. Got my so this must have been college. He's talking. Must have been college because maybe it could be high school. I'm guessing it's college. Got my payback that summer when we left on vacation. I set my radio alarm to go off at 3 a.m. the following morning at full volume. She called the cops, and eventually my parents got the call, but we were 5 hours away. Played it off that I forgot to shut my alarm off. Dad knew better, but I didn't get in too much trouble as she complained about everything, so we kind of chuckled it off. Luckily, we had some taking care of the cats, so they had to come over at 6 a.m. to turn the radio off. So that's a revenge story of a party gone wrong, where his party got busted. He said, okay, I'm going to get my revenge by setting the alarm to go off at 3 in the morning when I'm on vacation. I like Ian and East Troy. He's a good contributor to the show. That's a little in poor taste, as Tausch likes to say, a little IPT.
I think so. Yeah, no doubt.
All right, I'm gonna take a gamble here. I'm going to start to read this text without proofreading it. So if we get to a spot where especially on what we're doing, if there is something here that we shouldn't be able to talk about,
slow
here,
down.
Then I'm gonna you're gonna hear me stutter all of a sudden. Here we go. This is from Neil in Florida. This is a true story. My second son, who is now 42 years old, was 17, 18, and a senior in high school, and our family was living in Southern California. He was working for a rather large candy company. My wife and I headed to Vegas for a weekend, leaving strict instructions for no parties while we were gone. This is already sounding like it's going to be a nightmare. I haven't proofread. I don't even know how this ends yet. We went on the road 2 hours, and my good friend across the street and a federal agent called me to say that cars are lined up on both sides of the street at least 30 deep. Oh, my God.
He had a blowout.
My son was an all-state football player and semi-popular. That's a humble brag. My friend asked me, what do you think? This party will get busted as most kids look underage. He said, do you want me to do a raid entry, flash my badge, and give them 5 minutes to exit, or what? Well, he told me he never saw so many kids run fast, hightailing it out of the house and out of the neighborhood. As his son watched his friend's exit, he handed his friend the keys to our second car, and he was now grounded. Needless to say, we had a great laugh and learning life experience. My son turned out okay. Yeah. He served in the Navy for over 20 years as a submarine. All right, well, thank you for your service, son of Neil in Florida. Legitimately, we say that. That's great amazing. Story. Yeah, my buddy across great the street story. Is a federal agent. You want me to go break up the party?
I think you should, yes.
And he was so flashes the bat. Federal agent, walk everybody in, out walk, of here. You have 5 minutes to screw. That. That's so good.
Walk in on that.
844. Yes, that's so good. 844-770-3776. Continue to take your stories of parties being left home alone that have gone wrong, inspired by Jason and Tausch leaving us home alone to run the show while they have decided to take a couple of days off. Gary, I did promise we were going to get to these NFL power rankings. We can do it quickly here. I don't know if I don't want to tease it out to another day, and we got trivia still to get to. Hunter's going to take over. We still got to do that. We got all kinds of fun. So let's go ahead.
We got stuff going on.
Let's go ahead and let's hit the music as we take a look at the ESPN NFL Power Rankings. Oh, yeah. Love it. Here we go. These are the Power Rankings for the NFL, according to ESPN's NFL Nation. That's the usual group that we have. So Rob Domofsky and every Rob Domofsky for every team around the country. They put together these rankings. And this is post-free agency. So they did a pre-free agency power ranking. I'm sure we'll have one post-draft. This is post-free agency power rankings. Gary Ellerson, before I spoil it for you, Where do you believe the Green Bay Packers should be ranked among all NFL teams? Post-free agency, pre-NFL draft, where do you think they land among the ranks of the National Football League?
So is this including saying that they, when they got Xavier McKinney
yep,
and
so
Josh Jacobs?
Every roster as currently constructed today. So Xavier
right
McKinney,
now.
Josh Jacobs, Aaron Jones on the Vikings, Kendricks in Dallas, the whole updated list.
Well, listen, you got the best safety in free agency, probably right now in all of football. He may be the best in the NFL. You got a young stud running back who led the league in rushing. Was that 2 years ago, I believe?
I believe 2 years ago he was the leading rusher, yes.
Yeah. Fell off a little bit last year. Hell, they should be number one. Who did better?
Well, Kansas City's number one. The two-time defending oh. Super Bowl. They're the two-time defending champs. It's the, almost
they
the,
did better?
Mahomes. Andy Reid. You just there's kind of this, like, remember how we felt. Don't fall into this trap, Gary. Remember how we felt going into the playoffs last year, where it was, Kansas City, they don't have it this year. Baltimore's better. All those other teams in the AFC.
So you're asking me who the best team is.
Yes. So I'm sorry. Maybe I didn't clarify that for you.
Not who had the best free agents.
Correct.
Free agents
yes. There is an argument. Yes, because I agree with you. There's an argument to be made. The Packers had the best free agent pickups of the offseason.
Yes.
There's definitely an argument to be said for
different.
That. No, what we're saying here, what the NFL Nation is reviewing is the best teams today entering. Yeah. If they all went to play games today, how are we ranking?
Fine.
So Kansas City is number one.
Most certainly Kansas City is number one. I don't have a certain order, but I put the Detroit Lions still in front of them.
Oh, that Detroit is number two.
I put the 49ers still in front of the Green Bay Packers.
You're good at this. They're three.
Are they? And then let me see who else in the AFC over there.
There's a couple of controversial picks here that I don't agree with. So let me.
No, give me the Packers at five, bro.
Yeah, I would say they should be top five. I agree. I think when you look at where the Green Bay Packers stand after the free agency pickups, with the trajectory that they finished the season on last year, and where you look at what other teams are doing this offseason or not doing, like, let me run through the list here. So the Packers check in at they are number 10. According to this list.
Oh, no way.
I think that's too low. Now, listen to some of the teams in front of them. I mentioned, and Gary, you nailed the top three.
Okay.
Kansas City 1, Detroit 2, San Francisco 3. That makes sense.
Okay.
San Francisco was in the Super Bowl last year. Detroit was in the title game and had a big lead. That all makes sense. None of those teams got worse.
You better not give me, Buffalo, Cincinnati. They can't. None of them jokers can't be in front of you.
Well, just you wait. Baltimore is number 4. Okay. I'm okay with that.
Okay. I'm okay with that.
The Buffalo Bills are number 5.
No.
I don't think anyone could argue the Buffalo Bills got better this offseason, especially relative to the Green Bay Packers. And they made it the same length in the postseason.
Well, they're descending. And the Packers are an ascending team to me.
Absolutely. Yeah, absolutely. The tumultuous.
They're going the other way.
I mean, Buffalo was lucky to get into the playoffs last year, and then they won a game, and they were up on Kansas City in that home game. But, they were lucky to get in last year. Miami is 6. Miami hasn't proven they can win anything yet. I'm sick of the Dolphins. They're the new Chargers. Look at the Dolphins. Look at Tua. Look at that offense. Oh, it's so skillful, so talented. Look at that head coach. He's great.
Guys run around. They can run around. They're innovative.
They haven't won anything. So you can't tell me the Dolphins are better than the Packers at this point. LaFleur's a much more accomplished head coach. The Eagles are 7. I don't know what to make of the Eagles because they've revamped some things this offseason, but they're losing some big pieces too.
Well, they lost the offensive coordinator and the defensive coordinator a couple years ago, and I think that's what hurt them this past year. Now their structure is not as sound as it once was with Jalen Hurts.
Yeah. I agree with that. I would put the Packers ahead of the Eagles in the NFC right now today. After the draft could be different, but I would say today.
And believe it or not, Jason Kelce hurts them. I don't know. To me, he's a Hall of Famer. I don't know how you replace a Hall of Famer like that.
He's an instant Hall of Famer. Yeah, there's no doubt about that.
Yeah.
That's going to be something they're going to have to address this offseason for sure. Houston is number 8. Houston's the buzz team this offseason.
Come on.
Everyone's all in on Houston. I heard Evan Cohen on Sportsmanlike say, you can't talk about the Packers and say all the good things about them and not say the same thing about the Houston Texans because okay. They're doing the exact
He's
same
right.
thing.
He's right.
Is he? Like, Jordan Love's in his fifth season. CJ Stroud's going into year 2. Like, let me make sure he's not going to have a sophomore slump.
Yeah, well, what CJ Stroud did was absolutely incredible.
He's very good. He was very good last year. Way better than I expected him to be.
I agree.
And Dallas is in at 9 ahead of the Green Bay Packers. Hunter, you're the Cowboys fan. Do the Cowboys belong ahead of the Packers? Right? The Packers put it on them in the playoffs.
There's no world where I would ever think right now that the Cowboys are better than the Packers. This is insane.
Yeah, so we should be moving the Packers up 3-4 spots minimum on this list. Always curious to see what the national perception is of the Green Bay Packers. We'll see what it is post-draft with a bunch of picks in the first few rounds. 844-770-3776. All right. Hunter, I'm taking your word for it here. We're not going to push back. We're still going to play trivia next. So don't go anywhere if you want to play trivia. But before we do, we have an anonymous caller who this person does not wish to reveal themselves. This isn't like a mystery caller like my brother-in-law. This is an anonymous caller.
This is anonymous. Okay. They wish to not have their identity known. I double-check the story. We're all good there.
This means that this story is going to have some juice to it. So, anonymous caller, welcome to Wildy and Tausch. What is your story of being left home alone?
Hello.
Yes.
Are you there?
Yes, we got you. It's hard for me to introduce anonymous caller. I guess I couldn't. Yes, you are on the air with Jesse and Gary.
Thank you. Good to be with you guys. So my party story is parents go to Florida every year for a couple of weeks. I'm a senior in high school. You know, the party starts to go, even though you've only invited 20 people, but all of a sudden there's about 100 people.
It's always
people,
more. Now there's always
about more. 150 people, right. And this was way before social media, so I don't even know how everybody found out, but they managed to, right? So about halfway through the party, more people are coming, and I'm realizing, you know, we're out of everything. We're out of food. We're out of drinks. So I leave to go get some more adult beverages and come back. Now, this was beer days, right? You could drink when we were 18. You could drink beer.
Right. Okay.
So I leave to go get some adult beverage, right? And I come back, and my boyfriend knew about this gigantic freezer of meat that we had in the basement. So he and his friends went down there and got about, I'm not kidding, probably 20 T-bone steaks out of the freezer and fed the entire party. I came back into steaks cooking in my kitchen. So, you know, I was totally busted. There was no way I could lie about not having a party this year.
Oh,
right?
My gosh. So, yeah.
The whole year's meat was gone.
Oh, goodness. So,
I guess I have to ask you, did you marry the boyfriend?
That's what I was going to ask, Gary. Great question. How long did this relationship last after this incident?
Not much longer. Not necessarily because of this incident, but it didn't help. Let me tell you that.
20 T-bone steaks were just sitting down in the freezer for the year's worth of steak.
Yeah,
and they were all under the broiler. They were sensational. I had one myself because it was too late.
I mean, as long as they're cooking, you might as well, right? You're gonna get busted.
That's right, exactly.
You're gonna get busted. Might as well on a full belly, no doubt. Thanks so much for the call. That was a great story. 844-770-3776. That's amazing. I love that we've been doing this today. This is so much fun. You can continue to share your stories. Text them in now on the text line, or you can also share them on the Wildy and Tausch Twitter feed at Wildy and Tausch. 844-770-3776. I share that phone number because it is time to play Wildy and Tausch Trivia. Today's category for caller number 10. Caller number 10. Squads in the Sweet 16. It is Sweet 16 day. You know, college basketball, their little tournament they do every year. They're picking up the Sweet 16 tonight. So four games on the docket tonight. Caller number 10. How well do you know the squads in the Sweet 16? 844-770-3776 is the talk and text line. That's where you come in to play trivia. 844-770-3776. Caller 10. We will play trivia next after we leave this segment with Mark Tauscher. I wonder how many parties he had with ice-cold Coors Light back in the day. It's Wildy and Tausch.
Mark Tauscher here for the Blue Mountains of cold, refreshing Coors Light. Whether you're celebrating your favorite team winning or you just need a moment to chill, crack open a Rocky Mountain cold Coors Light. Coors Light is brewed with a three-step cold process, cold lager, cold filtered, and it is cold packaged, so it is actually made to chill. The mountains on Coors Light's cold-activated bottles and cans turn blue when chilled to perfection, which, besides the refreshing taste, is my favorite thing about drinking Coors Light. Refreshingly cold and only 102 calories, Coors Light is made to chill. Celebrate responsibly. Coors Brewing Company, Golden, Colorado.
The Milwaukee Bucks, the New Orleans Pelicans.
Back to Chris, fires away from three, and cash. Money Middleton is just that.
Tonight on Madison's home of the Bucks, 100.5 ESPN.
Mark Tauscher here to tell you a little bit more about Everlight Solar. We all know that electricity costs are on the rise. That's why you need to talk to my friends over at Everlight Solar. Their local team here in Madison is here to keep it simple. From your no-cost consultation to solar panel installation, the team at Everlight Solar will be with you every step of the way. Not only will they help you save money, but by switching to solar, you're also helping save the planet. Everlight Solar, a proud partner of Wisconsin Athletics. Check them out at everlightsolar.com.
You can drive cutting-edge design. 2024 Audis are on the lot and ready for delivery. You can save $7,500 on select Audi EVs with the AFS EV lease bonus. See dealer for details and exclusions. Eligibility is subject to credit approval through Audi Financial Services. Cannot be combined with national customer credit. Offer expires April 1st, 2024. Stop in and test drive today. Check out our website to see our current electric vehicle inventory and our monthly specials. The search for your Audi begins and ends at Zimbrick Audi of Madison, off the Beltline and Rimrock Road. Drive yours today.
When it comes to security for your home and family, you want a winner, and we found one when we placed our trust with J&K Security Solutions. This is Greg Gard. Kim and Jeff hit the game-winning shot for us with the Control 4 home technology system. Home or away, from our smartphones, we can open the garage door, dim the lights, turn on the TV, as well as arm the security system. That's convenience as well as peace of mind. Let J&K Security Solutions do for your home or business like they've done for us. Call 255-5799 or online at jksecurity.com.
You can't miss a moment with Greeny.
Three teams in the NFC South spent $250 million guaranteed dollars on these three quarterbacks who have played 28 seasons and won three playoff games. Kirk Cousins has been involved in more NFL games that ended in a tie than he has playoff wins. A tie happens like once every three NFL seasons. They have the playoffs every year.
Greeny, weekdays noon to 2 on 100.5 ESPN.
My name is Adrienne, and I was hurt in a car accident. What Gruber Lofts has done for me was made me feel safe. It didn't cost me anything, just one call, that's all.
Injured? Call Gruber Lofts today. One call, that's all.
Condon Jewelers, Condon Jewelers, the jeweler on the east side, the jeweler on your side. When you see Diamond Jim, you can count on him to be on your side. Selection beyond compare with on-site repair, so you can wear your jewelry with pride. Condon Jewelers, Condon Jewelers, the jeweler on the east side, the jeweler on your side.
There's a good chance if you watch sports, you're getting served information about hormone optimization. What does that even mean? Dr. Ness Rodriguez at Carbon World Health can tell you exactly what hormone optimization means. He will take your blood work and let you know if it's right for you. If you're feeling sluggish, not losing weight like you used to, you're not gaining muscle like you used to, or you just don't feel like yourself in most aspects of your life, go see Dr. Ness Rodriguez at Carbon World Health. In fact, sign up for the 6-week experience so you can see everything that Carbon World Health has to offer, including hormone optimization. Learn more at carbonworldhealth.com.
If you're an employer looking to tap into the next strong generation of local prospective employees, then you can't miss this. 95.3 WBEV ESPN Beaver Dam and DailyDodge.com will be hosting the South Central Wisconsin Career Expo on April 23rd. From 9:30 a.m. to 2 p.m. at the Beaver Dam High School Fieldhouse, businesses will have the opportunity to meet with hundreds of eager juniors and seniors from area high schools, as well as adult job seekers. Employers can find more information and purchase a booth on the Career Expo page at DailyDodge.com.
For official rules and more information about every contest on 100.5 ESPN, visit ESPNWisconsinContest.com. That's ESPNWisconsinContest.com. You're listening to 100.5 ESPN and the ESPN app.
Wildy and Tausch on 100.5 ESPN is brought to you by Everlight Solar. Save money, save the planet. Everlight Solar.
Wildy and Tausch. No Wildy, no Tausch. Jesse Nelson, Gary Ellerson, your cousin subs of the day. In for the guys, along with producer Hunter Vaughn running the show. 844-770-3776 is the ESPN Wisconsin Talk and Text line. And that is where we find Mike in Franklin to play today's round of Wildy and Tausch trivia. Mike, good morning. Did your parents leave you home alone today for you to call into the show?
No, I'm a little too old for that. But I think I'm even older than Gary. So.
Oh my goodness!
I'm no youngster.
You're old.
So you're leaving the kids home. You got to worry about them causing some trouble.
That's about it.
Well, Mike, we appreciate you tuning in and joining the show for Wildy and Tausch trivia today. Squads.
Hey, real quickly, I will let you know I snuck into. Game 5 of the World Series back in 1982, but I think the statute of limitations is done on that one.
You snuck,
I was 18 years old. I couldn't get a ticket. So I snuck in Gate X, the World Series.
Well, since the statute of limitations is up, how'd you do it?
It was Gate X. A friend of mine was apparently pretty prolific at getting in there. I had no idea, but we were able to sneak into the press gate X, and we went in and had our way around the whole stadium.
Love it.
That's that's a great story and also a little concerning. And if my dad had been an usher at County Stadium at the time, there is no way that Usher George would have let you in there, Mike. That would have been very safely guarded. All right, let's play some Wildy and Tausch trivia. Mike, have you been watching the NCAA tournament? Are you caught up on the teams playing in the Sweet 16?
I think so.
We're going to find out.
Yep.
Question number one for you, Mike and Franklin. A matchup tonight in a Sweet 16 game features a rematch of last year's national championship game with UConn facing which opponent? Florida. I'll give you some options if you want them, Mike. I don't know if you want to show off or if you want to. Like, you sounded like you were having some trouble with the question, so I'm going to help you.
No, go ahead. Sorry, I'm going to interrupt you.
Is it Florida Atlantic, San Diego State, or I fell asleep because they play that game so late?
They are playing San Diego State.
See, options help, Mike. You don't have to be a show-off. Yep. Everything's okay. And this is I put that answer in there as a public service announcement for everybody. It is a week and a half until the national championship game will be played on a Monday. They are again tipping that game off at 8:20 p.m. Central Time. I don't want to hear anybody complain about how late the national championship game is played. I'm giving you 10 days notice to get your naps in, adjust your sleep schedules accordingly, and plan to stay up to watch the game. It's going to be over before the 10 o'clock news. You'll be fine if you just plan a little bit accordingly. I don't want to hear anybody on that Monday say, oh, my God, they play the game so late. I don't want to stay up that late to watch. This happens every year. I'm getting ahead of it.
Sorry.
I'm on my soapbox. Sorry. Question two. Gary, I'm sorry. I forgot to ask you if you agree or disagree in our typical Gary Ellerson trivia
fashion. I agree.
You got it. All right. Nicely done, Gary.
I agree. Here we go.
Okay. Question two, Mike. Gonzaga holds the longest active streak of consecutive seasons reaching the Sweet 16. That's not a question. That's a fun fact. Here's the question. Which team in this year's Sweet 16 holds the second longest active streak? So Gonzaga's been to the most consecutive Sweet 16s. Who is second? Purdue, Houston, or Arizona?
I will go with Arizona. I'm not sure on that one, but
all right, Mike. Gary, do you agree?
Well, I'm with the guy's hand on the buzzer.
Hunter Vaughn is correct in asserting that Mike's guess was incorrect. The Houston Cougars, believe it or not, have been to four consecutive Sweet 16s. They have the second longest streak behind Gonzaga.
Okay.
And Mike's not thrilled by that. Okay. Nice. Anyway, we'll bounce back with the next one, potentially.
I was between Houston and Arizona, but I went with Arizona.
Yep. Well, you chose poorly.
That's okay. Yeah. I guess.
Question number three, Mike and Franklin. Which of these teams playing a Sweet 16 game tonight does not have a former Wisconsin Mr. Basketball High School Player of the Year on its current roster? So which of these teams playing tonight, who does not have a former Mr. Basketball in Wisconsin? North Carolina, Iowa State, or Alabama?
I'm going to go with Alabama.
Does not. And that is correct. Nicely done, Mike and Franklin. Alabama does not. North Carolina does. Iowa State does. And for good measure, Illinois playing tonight also does. Three teams in the Sweet 16 with former Mr. Basketballs from the state of Wisconsin participating in Sweet 16 games tonight. Mike, you got two of the possible three questions right, which means you have three of the possible four entries into the drawing, which Gary and I will remember to do tomorrow with the cheese fry helmet here in the Everlight Solar Studio. Thanks so much for playing, Mike. Appreciate you.
All right, guys. Have a good day. Thank you.
And I hope Mike isn't going to try to sneak into AmFam Field for the home opener on Tuesday. That would be frowned upon. Don't want to do that. Hunter Vaughn is the producer of the show. He's a Dallas Cowboys fan. We've heard from him talking Cowboys already. Let's see what else he has to offer. Coming up next, Hunter Vaughn takes over Woe Nelly for Woe Hunter on Wilde and Tausch.
This is Wilde and Tausch, driven by Zimbrick Chevrolet in Sun Prairie on 100.5 ESPN. See their full inventory at ZimbrickChevrolet.com.
Whether you're an artist playing accountant, a barista trying to be a bean counter, or a student just looking to get started, the UW Credit Union app lets you be free to be you. With free credit scores, free online bill pay, and the ability to send money to friends. Because with fewer fees, you can do more of what you love. UW Credit Union, here for every you. Join today at uwcu.org. Federally insured by NCUA.
The area's best high school sports coverage is Zimbrick Honda's presentation of Prep Mania.
And after four overtimes, we finally figure out the first team in the Division I state final. 99-95, our score. Arrowhead Warhawks.
Zimbrick Honda's Prep Mania is also brought to you by Canopy Wealth Management, Pasquale's Cantina, UW Credit Union, Stoughton Trailers, the GRB Academy, and Stoughton Health.
Get 0% interest for up to 3 years at Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. I'm Gina Della from Pella. Pella's free in-home consultations make replacing or redesigning your windows and doors easy. We go beyond just measuring and handing you a quote by listening and educating you on all of your product options. And with DesignWorks, you can see what your home will look like before you buy. Order by March 31st to get 0% interest for up to 3 years. Set your free consultation at PellaWI.com.
Certain restrictions apply.
Hey everyone, Molly Brown here from ESPN Madison. For the best Southwestern food and margaritas in the Madison area, it's always Pasquale's Cantina for me. Whether I'm enjoying my favorite taco salad, their awesome chips and guac, or one of their famous burritos, Pasquale's is the best for authentic Southwestern fare. Plus, they have one of the largest tequila selections around. Visit one of their locations in Verona or Middleton today, or check out their menu and order online at Pasquale'sCantina.com.
Bringing the flavors of the Southwest to the Midwest. Pasquale's Cantina.
Hey, it's Kyle Walsh here from ESPN Wisconsin's Kyle Bruston-Nortman, and I gotta tell you about one of my new favorite ways to watch games with the Underdog Fantasy Sports app, a pick'em fantasy game where you can win real money. It's easy to find in your app store and even easier to use. Here's how it works. Pick 2 to 5 players from at least 2 different teams, then select higher or lower on those player stats. If your picks hit, you can win up to 100 times your money. Yeah, it is that easy. Especially with the hoop season hitting high gear, you know I'm watching every game with the Underdog Fantasy app. So right now, head to their easy-to-use mobile app or underdogfantasy.com and sign up using promo code KBN. Underdog will match your first deposit up to $100. Plus, they'll give you a mystery special pick to use on your first pick'em entry. That's promo code KBN. Join me and get the Underdog Fantasy app so that you can enhance your game watching experience just like me. Must be 18+ and present in the state where Underdog Fantasy operates. Terms apply. Concerned with your play? Call 1-800-GAMBLER or visit ncpgambling.org.
Mark your calendars and get ready for game day at the 5th Annual Easter Seals Wisconsin Celebrity Basketball Experience, presented by Affiliated Dentists. Former UW athletes hit the hardwood on April 13th at Madison College to support children and adults with disabilities. Tip-off is at 3 p.m. And for some pregame action, be sure to register your kids grades 3 through 8 at the Shot Doctor Skills Academy from 1 to 2:30 with former UW men's basketball assistant coach Gary Close. All abilities welcome to register. Visit easterseals.com/gameday for more details.
Mark Tauscher here for Chalmers Jewelers. I've been a big fan of Scott and Garrett and the whole team at Chalmers Jewelers for years now. I go there, my friends go there, and most importantly, my wife loves it whenever I get her something from Chalmers Jewelers. What's right around the corner? Mother's Day. Show some love to the incredible women in your life and stop at Chalmers Jewelers, the place to go for that perfect gift. I recommend Chalmers Jewelers in Middleton and Madison.
Chalmers Jewelers in Middleton
and Madison.
Like, share, and follow ESPN Madison everywhere. Follow us on Twitter, Instagram, Facebook, and TikTok for more great content from ESPN Madison. This is 100.5 ESPN and Wisconsin On Demand.
I'm not afraid of getting old. I want less day from dying young. I see the light go past my shoulder.
How often do you guys have to reset your password on something? Like, it says, like, you can't remember what your password is to log in, you got to do the reset, it sends you the email, and then you got to come up with a new one, and then it says you used that one before, and then you got to do the whole deal. Gary, how often do you run into that? Or is that just something that happens to me more often than anybody?
Yeah, I think it happens to you more than anybody else.
Great. Hunter, is this yeah, unique to me or what?
Nah, yeah.
I'm maybe once a year.
That's what? Yeah, this maybe. Happened. It's been like 5 times this week for, like, I'm trying to get a haircut tomorrow. I'm trying to do an online registration for a hair, and what's your password? And I tried like 8 passwords. Nope, that's not it. That's not it. That's not it. So I got to do the whole reset thing. Right. It sends you an email. Got to click the link, do a double up password. Very frustrating.
Well, you know, I used to work for a Verizon store, and we would give all the boomers a sheet of paper for them to write their stuff down on. I might have that file still. I could just pass that along to you.
That's not very nice, Hunter. That's not very nice. That's not. All right. If that's going to set the mood, let's play Whoa, Hunter. Yeah.
If the topic is good, whoa, the guys discuss. Nelly.
Just the other morning, I had breakfast at Tracy Rocker's house. His mama brought out 15 flapjacks. He said, mama, take back 5 of them flapjacks. I got to stay hungry for the Crimson Tide.
But if it's not, the show must go on. It's time for
Whoa, Nelly
on Wildy and Tausch.
All right, I wasn't going to bring this up at all, and I just stumbled across this tweet a little while ago. With both Indiana State and Seton Hall still alive in the NIT, and it's looking like both of them will advance to the final, this tweet idea was, if you win the NIT, you get an auto bid into the NCAA tournament the next season. Do we like this idea, Gary?
Yeah, I think I do, because I think there are more teams should be playing in NIT that are not going. To me, I just don't get that to save my life. I think the more games you play, the better you're going to get. Even if some of these guys are not on your team next year, but it's still the development of players. Yeah, let me get down with that.
Nobody, I say this as a Missouri Valley Conference alum, just like Gary's daughter. Nobody is going to want to watch Indiana State basketball next year. They're fun this year. They should have been in the tournament this year instead of a bunch of teams that got in. They had a really good squad. I saw them in St. Louis when we went to the Arch Madness Missouri Valley Conference tournament. They were really good. Fan base is great, rejuvenized. The Missouri Valley Conference, like all the top like 15 players are transferring. They're all going into the transfer portal. Indiana State's players are either going to transfer or graduate. after this season, because no one wants to stay in Terre Haute, Indiana, if you're having that good of a season and you're getting offers from Arkansas and from USC and from Washington to go join these new teams. Nobody's going to want to stay in Terre Haute, Indiana. That's the game this time. Like, that's what it is now. It sucks because 10 years ago, I would say, yes, this is a great idea. You know, make the NIT something worthwhile. That's more than just building your team for the following year and getting some tournament experience and a chance for another team to win its final game. That's not the case anymore. The teams that are competing in the NIT, just like teams that are in the NCAA tournament, are not going to be the same teams that they are next year. You would be rewarding a team that's probably going to finish bottom four in their conference next year, because that's what they've been for every year except for this year. And no one wants to watch that team go into the NCAA tournament next year. So
no, but I think you made a great point. I think you make a great point, and that point is because those players will be good, they will be going to bigger schools with bigger money.
Yeah, I mean, Bradley already had a player that was an all-conference player. He's in the transfer portal. He's going somewhere else. And congratulations to him. He's going to get a great opportunity somewhere. But 15 players at the top of that and that's a good basketball conference. Like, that's not a really super low-tier conference. It's a decent mid-major conference. 15 players, only the ones but Indiana State, they don't know what's going to happen. All the other players, except for one, graduating or transferring. Crazy.
Whoa, Nelly!
And then quickly, because we did not manage the clock well at all
that
today.
That tends to happen around this segment, just so you know, this is nothing new.
No, so Gary, you weren't around to know about this, but back last summer, I had made a bet with my wife. We were both over the Barbie movie and the Oppenheimer movie, which movie would do better opening weekend. I got crushed on that bet, and I agreed to get a tattoo designed by my wife. We've had a few fans of the show over the last few months texting in who remember that, and I needed to give an update.
I've forgotten about this story. Yeah, where are we at with the tattoo?
I'm going to be going in to get it scheduled on Monday. The design that we're going to try and figure out with my tattoo artist will be the state of Wisconsin, and then something with like the capital or the isthmus inside of it. And then that's the design that we're going to go with.
Oh, come on.
That was the design that my wife came up with.
You're not even putting Barbie on it at all?
She didn't want to do that. It was her decision to design it how she wanted to, and that's what she came up with.
That's so
I just wanted to update the fans that I am following through on my bet.
Where are we getting the tattoo at, Hunter? Do we know what part of the body?
It'll be on my forearm. It's kind of hard to show on the video stream, but I've got an open space right there because I've got a couple other ones here. So I'm going to fill in that space on my arm.
What is it? Is that a knife? Is that a sword on your
arm? It is Luke's green lightsaber from Return of the Jedi.
Oh, boy.
Because I'm a big nerd.
Yeah.
It's great. Okay. So I've got that.
What else
and then,
you got there?
It is a peony, which is my wife's favorite flower, and then it has our anniversary date underneath it.
Oh, God, oh, my goodness, you're such a lovely young man.
Well, thank you. That might be the best compliment I have ever gotten on air on ESPN Wisconsin. Thank you so much.
Your parents did well.
You're such a lovely young man.
Lovely young man.
Parents remember that, Jesse, when I'm annoying.
The lovely young man, Hunter Vaughn.
What is it, a Pyrenees flower, you say? What is it?
A peony. It's her favorite flower. Yep.
I heard
it's a big pink.
So you've got her favorite flower on you, and now you're going to get a tattoo that she likes the most.
Yes. I told her I would never get – I won't get a portrait done because those can look terrible, and I will not get her name put on me because I firmly believe that is a death sentence to relationships.
God. Oh, that –
getting your name, getting someone else's name tattooed on your body is a death sentence to that relationship. Don't ever do it.
That means that you're going to get a divorce if you get the name?
I think it's the beginning of the end.
But he's got the anniversary date. What's the difference in having the anniversary date or the name? It's the same signifying thing.
The date is some numbers.
Double down on it.
The date is some numbers. I'm not getting the name.
God
forbid
something bad happens, and then you meet someone else. You're going to say, hey, we have to get married on this day. I already got it right here on the old forearm.
Yeah.
Right next to Luke's lightsaber.
Yep. But I won't get the name. Not doing it.
Whoa, Nelly!
That's it for Whoa, Nelly, featuring Hunter Vaughn, our cousin sub producer of the day. He's a lovely young man. Gary and I will wrap it up. I will choose one. I will choose one more great Home Alone story from the text line to wrap up today's edition of Wildy and Tausch. We'll share that with you next. Don't go anywhere. It's Wildy and Tausch.
The Milwaukee Bucks, the New Orleans Pelicans.
Back to Chris, fires away from three, and cash. Money Middleton is just that.
Tonight on Madison's home of the Bucks, 100.5 ESPN. You, rah, rah. Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin present your Badger Minute. Here's Alex Stroff.
This Badger Minute brought to you by the Great Dane Pub and Brewing Company, Madison's home for craft beer and pub food since 1994. Find the Great Dane nearest you at greatdanepub.com.
Longtime Wisconsin State Journal columnist Jim Polzin joined Kyle Bruston-Nortman on ESPN Wisconsin earlier this week and compared the current state of men's basketball coach Greg Gard to former football coach Paul Christ's hot seat and what it would take to move on from Gard.
I didn't think Chris McIntosh would fire Paul Christ, but again, something in that two-hour conversation changed Chris McIntosh's mind, and I think it would take a similar conversation with Greg Gard probably to get him to the point where he's ready to move on and find someone new.
Find the full conversation with Jim Polzin on Wisconsin on demand or wherever you get your podcasts.
Get no interest for up to 3 years at Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. Don't wait. You have to order by March 31st. Visit PellaWI.com.
Since 1956, Holman Lindsay Paints has been making paint in Wisconsin for Wisconsin. Because of their commitment to making great paint for Wisconsinites, Holman Lindsay has grown over the years to 26 locations in this great state. Headquarters in Sun Prairie with a state-of-the-art facility, Holman Lindsay has the paints you need to make your job better. From do-it-yourself to professional, Holman Lindsay has paint for everyone. Visit one of their local locations today in Madison, Sun Prairie, Middleton, and Janesville.
To those who've ever dreamt of their perfect event, those dreams are worthy and they are possible. Hi, it's Jeffrey from Celebrations Entertainment. With hard work, passion, and great music, we will make your event dreams a reality. Every event is a labor of love, with one-on-one planning, customization, and flawless execution. Bringing your event to life is what we do. For a fun, memorable event, visit CelebrationsEntertainment.com. That's CelebrationsEntertainment.com.
The GRB Rays have established themselves as one of the top baseball programs in the Midwest and the country. GRB Academy offers training programs for players of all ages and skill levels. Learn from some of the best baseball coaches in the area and find the program that fits your training goals and your schedule. Spots are filling up fast, so visit GRBacademy.com to sign up now. That's GRBacademy.com. GRB Academy, baseball for the serious player.
Greg Scalzo here for Buck and Honey's. Congratulations to the perennial Best of Madison Award winner by the folks at Madison Magazine. Meet me at Buck and Honey's to celebrate Wisconsin hospitality. Whether you're enjoying the view on the Yahara River in Monona, exploring Wanakee, visiting the OG in Sun Prairie, or checking out the new location in Mount Horeb, you can enjoy the Buck and Honey's experience in a neighborhood near you. Serving lunch and dinner 7 days a week with brunch every Saturday and Sunday. I'll see you at Buck and Honey's.
You can drive cutting-edge design. 2024 Audis are on the lot and ready for delivery. You can save $7,500 on select Audi EVs with the AFS EV lease bonus. See dealer for details and exclusions. Eligibility is subject to credit approval through Audi Financial Services. Cannot be combined with national customer credit. Offer expires April 1st, 2024. Stop in and test drive today. Check out our website to see our current electric vehicle inventory and our monthly specials. The search for your Audi begins and ends at Zimbrick Audi of Madison, off the Beltline and Rimrock Road. Drive yours today.
You're probably being overwhelmed with information about semaglutide, the game-changing FDA-approved weight loss treatment. Jim Rutledge here. I was like you. I didn't know what it was until I saw Dr. Nestor Rodriguez at Carbon World Health. He can walk you through the benefits. He can tell you if it's right for you, and then you could come up with a plan to change your life with a workout plan and semaglutide. With that plan, I dropped from 20% body fat to 10% body fat, and I dropped over 20 pounds of fat and kept my muscle. You can do the same thing. Go see Dr. Nestor Rodriguez at Carbon World Health.
From the preps,
Russell spins his way into the paint with contact, finishes, and a foul.
That was pretty.
To the pros,
Beverly launches from three, and he knocks it down.
The biggest games play on 100.5 ESPN.
Jesse Nelson, Gary Ellerson in for Wilde and Tausch today and tomorrow. Excited to spend tomorrow with you as well here on the old program. As we've said throughout the day, mom and dad have left us home alone to take care of the house while they're gone for the rest of the week, which has led to some amazing stories from our fans and from Gary and Hunt, not so much from me, on the ESPN Wisconsin talk and text line, 844-770-3776. I leave you with this from Paul in the 608 on the text line. Had a party one night at the folks' house. All was good. House was cleaned up. 2 days later, my mother asked why there was beer in the dryer. There was a cops scare that night, and I guess someone dumped a couple glasses of beer in the dryer to hide them quickly. No cop showed up. Great friends. Quick, hide the beer. Oh, cool. Oh no, the
hide
cops
the beer.
Are coming. Where do we go? The dryer. Right. Put it in the dryer. It'll dry.
That's like the broken glass in the doggone in the doggone planter.
In the flower pot that you said that your son
in the flower
did.
Pot.
Yep.
Yeah. That's how he got caught.
If you're gonna hide it,
if I had never seen the broken glass in the flower pot, I would have never known.
You would have believed the sticky on the ground was just a can of juice or something. Yep.
Just a can of juice, like he said he wastes. I would have never known it.
Could have been anything. Jerry out in Canton, Ohio. Just like I agree with Tausch, you're a lovely young man. Gary Ellerson needs to be on a shirt. We'll get Jason Wilde on creating that for us. Gary, excited to do it again tomorrow. Thanks so much, man.
Let's do it tomorrow, buddy.
For Gary Ellerson, producer Hunter Vaughn, I'm Jesse Nelson. On behalf of Jason and Tausch, as Jason always says, have a great day. Take care. Be good.
Miss any of today's episode of Wilde and Tausch, presented by Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin? Commercial-free, full-show podcast.